Put the zebra over on the left side so everybody can see Chad on the right side.
That damn zebra. He's cool.
What about a zebra? Everything is made better with a zebra.
I see no zebra.
If you go to his Twitch, you will see a zebra.
Oh, it's on Twitch.
Yeah, I have a dancing zebra. And it's like a 20-minute video of this guy in a zebra costume dancing and sitting and reading a newspaper and posing and all kinds of crazy shit.
Why?
Because everything is better with a guy in a zebra costume. I should probably make a race of bunny people. Spooky bunny people. For Easter.
Is he just dancing with the
sign? Yeah, that's one of the things he does. It's like a... I'm serious. It's 20 minutes of him doing different stuff. And I have it set to just loop.
Oh, jeez.
Like, already?
There's a point where he's just reading a newspaper, and he hits the newspaper like, I cannot believe it, or he'll read it and shake his head.
Yeah, we name everything ourselves.
Yeah, you guys are all headed to Fort Starbutt. All right, finally.
Remember, I didn't name the towns. I had nothing to do with naming the towns.
In any case, all right, roll your condition. You're just now waking up on the 5th of summer in a cabin.
I thought we didn't have to roll condition because we're in the cabin.
Yeah.
No, you have to roll condition every day, regardless of being in a cabin or not. That's how you wake up.
You said last Saturday, no condition check.
No, I said no camping check.
Yeah, he's right. No camping check.
Okay, so Alyssa's not feeling too great, but at least she's not, like, terrible.
I drank too much with zombie.
So I still have a plus one to my condition or no?
You can never drink too much.
I don't think I
Oh my god, nobody ate yesterday.
You know, the beer and the...
Oh my god, you're right.
I'm feeling great.
Do I still have my modifier, yes or no? I don't think I do.
It is not spring, if that's what you're talking about, Queenie. It's summer.
Okay, so I do not have a... Well,
no, nobody has a modifier. Everybody ate normal food last time.
Ooh, I'm feeling good.
Queenie feels like $1 million.
Oh, yeah.
That's a 10, not an 11.
I got an 8. I'm feeling great.
I got a 5.
Yeah, me and Nordy had a rough night.
Okay.
Well, you both got drunk.
Now, we're going to say that.
I blame the wet t-shirt contest.
Right?
How dare you blame the glorious art of the wet t-shirt contest?
So, Walrus and Hound are not going to be joining you today because they are so hungover. They're just so hungover that they're just like, so you just don't even want to deal with them.
That sounded more like a zombie than a hungover.
Yeah.
So they're like me in the morning?
Yeah.
In the morning, every morning.
Or me. I hate mornings.
It's
awful thing.
Since it is morning, Queenie, do you want to do any searching?
Yes. I will go ahead and search for herbs.
Okay.
I need to do my check.
While she's out searching for herbs, what does everybody want to do? Since there's not going to be much movement today, what does everybody else think they're doing?
Oh crap! What is the herb check? Hold on. Can I search in this?
There we go. Herb check is strength plus intelligence.
Strength plus intelligence. All right, mm-hmm. I'm going to go ahead and make that as a macro real fast.
I might want to go hunting or something. Okay. I don't know.
You said strength plus intelligence?
Uh-huh.
Wanted to look at pricing.
I'm going to sit here and sharpen my swords.
So everybody's just staying in the cabin except for Queenie who's gone out?
I want to get a nap before we leave.
Yeah. I kind of want to see if I can't find some armor.
There's a general store, is there not?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a general store, but they don't sell any armor. They only sell general goods and camping goods. Okay, Queenie, that doesn't find you anything, unfortunately.
Well, poops. All right.
All right. So, a couple of things. One, it's raining today. So, Queenie and Elisa go outside, it begins to rain. Just the thunder and the rain already. Actually, just rain. Just rain, rain.
Oh, there's herb gathering at the top.
And, Elisa, as you are walking towards the general store to check it out, you hear yelling, and then you see two Neko-Goblins hightailing it away from the main office for the cabins with bows in their arms, and they're just running for glory. You know, one of them's holding his pot to make sure it doesn't fall off. The other's just got his arms full, his paws, sorry, full of bows. And it's just like, ah! And the innkeeper bursts out the front door, shaking his fist, doing the normal, like, come back here kind of thing that you would expect an innkeeper to do.
I'm gonna poke my head back into the cabins and let everyone know that what's going on, and then head to the office to see what's going on.
All right, settle up, sea biscuits.
Queenie, as a cat, you see your kin doing this as you're coming back from a failed attempt at find the rain was just too much to find any. What is it? Sweet apples.
Yeah.
In grasslands, it's called sweet apples. Well, in Gothage, it's sweet pumpkins. But it's been pretty much the same effect. So, nothing today. So, Queenie, what are you doing now that you've just seen your kin? They're hightailing it south, and you were up at the north, we'll say.
I'm wondering what they're doing, and I would go after them. Trying to figure out what they were doing. Since they are my kin.
Oh, and you would also know these aren't Koneko goblins. They're proper Neko goblins.
The bigger ones.
They're bigger ones, yeah. They're slightly larger than you are.
So, yeah, I would be yelling after them, chasing after them, like, hey.
Go touch them in the butt. Touch them in the butt.
What is Nordian Zombie doing?
I've already walked out of the cabin.
Okay. What are you doing outside?
Looking for these Neko goblins that supposedly ran off with a bunch of bows.
Okay, let's see. I will say, Elisa, since you grabbed everybody, you won't be able to catch up with the Neko goblins now. Queenie, I'll give you one chance to catch up with them. Roll a dexterity and a dexterity strength check.
Dexterity strength check?
Yep, you are on all fours trying to get him down, so.
Okay, that'll be a travel check then.
Yeah, sure.
Go through.
Wow. That's.
I'm speedy.
Yeah, much higher than I expected. Man, you're feeling good, even in the rain. I don't know, do Koneko like goblins rain. Like rain?
They might, I don't know. I'm assuming they do. As long as the fur doesn't get too wet.
Your fur's bristling. All right, you actually catch up to them. You don't catch them, but you catch up. You're within running distance of them, and they are not stopping for you. What do you do, or what do you say?
Trying to yell out to them, stop, stop.
No time to stop. Humans after us.
Why are humans after you? What did you do?
We kind of took everything. Well,
why did you take things?
It's. We gotta go.
Where are you going?
Wait, are you on the human side?
I'm like you. What are you doing?
We're taking bows. We need bows.
Why do you need bows?
Come on, it's obvious. There are wolves around. We need bows. We need so many bows.
I killed some of them. I can help you. Stop.
No, we gotta. They're still going. By the way, at none of this time do they actually stop. But let me think. What would they do? Well, they would continue. It's like no. Big Cat says keep going. We keep going.
Big Cat. Who's Big Cat?
Big Cat. Come on, Big Cat.
Big Cat.
You. What is your history with your kin, Queenie?
What the history with my kin?
Actually, I'm going to call him Top Cat from now on because that's
Top
cute.
Cat.
Anyway, so I never actually asked, did you grow up with your kin or were you raised by Wall? Is that why you hang on his head? What is going on between you and the shop? Why are you with all these humans?
I was raised with the humans, but I recognized them as my own, as my kin. Not humans, but other conecos.
Okay. So you know city conecos, not the country conecos.
Yes.
Okay, you don't know who Top Cat is.
Exactly.
Okay, if you want to keep running with them, roll again. And try to roll a 7 or... yeah, that's about right. Try to roll a 7 or higher.
Okay.
No.
All right.
You're out of breath. You city cats can't keep up with these country cats, and they just see. Well, you would normally see their dust behind them, but it's raining.
It's raining.
So. They eventually disappear into the distance, dropping like one bow behind them.
All right, I'm just gonna wait and see if everyone else catches up with me because I have a feeling they're gonna be coming after me.
So what's everybody else doing?
Well, I'm going to go in and ask the management office what happened since I'm still back here.
Goddamn Neko-Goblins just stole all our bows!
Why?
He points at the empty arsenal. Like, why? I don't know, they're Neko-Goblins? Why don't you go and ask them? In fact, you know what? I will pay you if you bring me back my bows.
Wait. All right. I'll go and see what I can do, and I take off after everyone else to let them know what's going on.
What's your offer, shopkeeper?
Can I get a bow?
You know what? Bring back the bows, and I will buy them back from you. So I'll pay you $350 per bow.
$400.
Man, I didn't know we had Hound in here already.
Right?
Yeah, it's like, what is Hound doing here? Hound, you're here, finally!
Jesus! Like, shit, dog.
Right? He's learned so much from Hound.
Make it 400, I'll go after them. I'll bring some hides, too.
400 a bow.
Got it.
Oh, my.
I think I'll be after everybody. What? I want to make a profit.
Do I need to do a stat check to run off or what?
There's no way you can catch up with them. The only person who had the chance. But, I mean, you can track down because Elisa... Everybody saw Queenie hightail it literally to the south to try and catch up.
Well, so I'm going to head south and track. Animal track because she's an animal, right?
Yeah. Although it's going to be rough in this rain, but yeah, you can do it. Roll your track.
5.
Nah.
Well, we can try Morty. Morty's got the same.
Okay. Ooh, damn, yeah, Morty, you got their tracks. You're completely on their trail.
Take that modifier off. I don't know why it was even there.
I'm not going to worry about the modifier. You're way over what you need to do in order to find them. It was like 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I gotta count out loud, my bad.
It did wake him up.
Anyway, yeah, you do a great tracking job. In fact, Nordy, once you arrive over at Queenie, you automatically see, like you're looking at the ground and you automatically see that they've run back and forth so much that they've practically left a trail right to their hideout.
That's nice.
They're not that smart, are they?
They dropped the bow, too. In the process. They're taking them to Top Cat?
If you guys are picking up these bows, each bow is a size 3. Just a reminder. And there's nothing unusual about these bows. They're just there. They're just bows that were meant for security for the inn.
Alright, I pick up the bow.
Yeah, they're taking the Top Cat. I don't know who Top Cat is. I've never heard of this Top Cat.
Does Nathan, Top Cat wear a top hat?
He does now.
But They said they needed them for the wolves, to get rid of the wolves.
It must be more of those dreadwolves that we fought earlier.
Must be. They must be planning something.
How far away are we from town?
Right now,
I would say we're just probably past the forest line.
You guys have been moving for like maybe 5 minutes. You're 5 minutes away from the cabins. From the town, the nearest town is 4 days away, and that's town.
Cabins, sorry.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I figured you meant the cabins. You've only been running for 5 minutes.
Okay, well, I would suggest we go back to the cabins and ask if anybody knows who this top cat person is. But Nordy might want to continue tracking him.
I want to continue tracking, so whatever.
Let's keep tracking to find out.
Yeah. Let's just keep tracking him.
Okay. It goes on for quite a while. Everybody go ahead and make a travel check. Okay. Oh, hell. My internet's flubbered up. Hang on a second. I might ditch out for a second.
Ooh, I got a critical success.
I tripped over a rock.
Yes, you did. You fell into a hole.
I got a 9. That's not bad.
That is bad.
Okay. Sorry about that. Holy shit. Queenie got a critical success.
I gotta revive. I'm good.
I have got to check out what the critical success thing is. Like, what happens. Okay. So, give me just a second. This is why I put little tabs on my thing. All right, you guys are making a direction check. Critical. Queenie, make a little note around you somewhere. On the next day's condition, you get a +1. You just...
Okay.
Man, this is cat territory. You are so ready for this. And in fact, it makes you invigorated. And you're fucking invigorated from feeling great this morning. You're just like, nyan. Fucking nyan, man.
Oh, yeah.
All right. The terrain check around here is 7, so everybody needs a 7 or better.
4.
Yeah, Alyssa, or Larissa, you're great.
Zombie phone.
Nordy is fine. Zombie? Zombie?
Or hit a tree.
Yeah. Zombie, you are not suited for this. This is... I realize that you're very stabby, but this is quite different from what you expected travel to be when you were in your highfalutin palace. What exactly did you do, if you don't mind me asking, that caused you to lose half your health?
Oh!
What?
See that rock right there? That rock decided I
needed
to hug the ground real quick with my face.
Oh man, you hate that rock. That you and that rock are now nemesis.
I snapped the rock.
Why would you?
I will let you kill the rock if you whisper something into at it.
Oh god. Oh god.
Wow. All right. How do I whisper? How do I whisper?
You just tell me what you whisper to the rock before you stab it.
I whispered to the rock before you're in this. My blade's going in dry.
Man, that rock's never going to hurt you or anybody else again. That rock is toast.
Yes.
It splits in half.
Oh, God.
Side note, remember this rock for later.
Guys.
Okay, you don't know how long you guys have been traveling, but it's been going along the same kind of route. Nordy has been following it. Actually, it's to the point now where Queenie and Nordy can see the track perfectly fine. Alyssa and Zombie, you're kind of in the dark, but you at least know that they know where they're going.
So wait, Zombie really did lose half of his health?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's what happens when you fail a travel check.
On a scale of 1 to max health, how do you feel right now, Zombie?
I glare at Nordy, pointing my dagger at him.
You can't do shit to me, dog.
I'm gonna cast my heal +++ or cure +++ at him.
Sure, roll a magic check.
Remember, you gotta slap him on the ass and say boo.
Oh yeah, you gotta slap him on the ass and say boo.
Yeah, hold on.
Touch the butt.
Yeah, I'm gonna slap him on the ass and say boo.
Which Magic check, I believe. Well, shoot.
Isn't it sense, intelligence, and spirit?
Yeah, it's intelligence and spirit, but I guess that's the macro they already have set up for it.
Okay.
Okay, which is fine. All that you're trying to do is not crit. Otherwise, the magic fizzles. All right, go ahead and subtract 6 MP, 4 for Cure Touch, and 2 more, right, for Cure Plus Plus?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's 2, so it's 6 total. And then you roll your intelligence, and 1d6.
Okay, hold on a sec.
Sure.
So... intelligence?
Yep, your intelligence should be like... there we go. If I remember right, you have like a normal intelligence.
Intelligence is 1d6.
Okay, so roll 2d6.
2d6. So then it's backslash...
Yep, backslash roll and then space 2d6.
That's right.
Wow. All right, zombie, you just got a really good feeling slap on the ass. And it doesn't go above your max.
Watch where you're going, dude.
I was watching where I was going. I was watching as the ground came up.
He's got you there. So after a good long journey, almost a day's journey, you guys are in the square south of the cabin right here.
Are we there
on your screen? You eventually follow the tracks, and it leads into a pretty small graveyard. In the middle of the graveyard, kind of on a mound, is a crypt.
Okay.
It is not night yet when you get there, but the... Which may be, well, no, I guess good or bad in your favor, because there is a single guard, Neko, guarding the front of the crypt.
Who wants to go to the creepy place first with me?
I would like to, do some kind of, checking to see what's...
Okay, you cut out. Could you say that again?
Something like that before we get in.
We'll be fine. Come on.
Okay.
Well, wait. What's the plan here?
Exactly.
Where's the plan?
I can talk to them. I mean, I am them. They might let me in.
Yeah, see if Queenie can talk to them. That might work.
Fine. I will listen to reason.
For now.
We don't have time to listen to reason. Anyway, it's up to you guys. I will remind you, Quinny, and you know this, they're bigger than you, and that means you're lower on the totem pole for them.
Yeah.
I walk over there with Quinny.
Okay, are you Nordy?
Nope, that's zombie.
Okay.
I'll walk over with her if you want me to. I got my walking stick out.
I just haven't got used to your voices yet. Sorry. Actually, you know what? I can fix that. I can set this up so I can see who's talking.
There you go.
That would probably be a good idea, mate.
Oh, which reminds me, you guys hear a cricket somewhere.
Cool. I step on the cricket.
You don't see the cricket. You merely hear it. Are you searching for it?
That's a waste. That's a waste of an almost semi-decently good roll.
So, okay, Zombie and Queenie are approaching the crypt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, who's going first?
I guess I'll go first.
This is purely for role-playing effort. It doesn't actually mean it. Oh, and I'll take over What's-His-Face's job for now. There's a...
Oh,
What do you mean, What's-His-Face?
Hound. He's taking over for Hound.
What's the cartographer? Oh, yeah.
Yes, cartographer.
It looks more like a church.
It'll work for now.
Neko-Crypt.
Neko-Crypt.
Okay. There we go. Okay.
Whoa. All right, so I approach the larger Kaneko.
There's only the one.
The one, okay. Well, they're larger than I am.
Yeah, they are all Neko goblins as far as you've ever seen. The two that were running from you and this guy right here, who is different.
Who is different, okay.
Different how?
Yeah, different how.
No, he's just different from the other Neko goblins.
Okay, different.
Let's say they all have chalk markings, like tribal markings on their face. And they're all resembling of skulls, but this one has a different skull, and it's in green. And he's kind of furrowed up because it's raining, and he doesn't like that.
I want you as a pet.
Oh my god, no.
Don't make me snort whiskey through my nose.
Zombie, before we proceed any further, I'm going to need you to stop there. Hold the stupid until after we're done with these guys.
Listen to the leader.
Okay, walking up to someone we haven't met is like, go, I want you as a pet. That's basically what we did in Africa, so stop it.
Oh my god! Dude, I'm gonna have to edit that out. Side note, I'm not editing that out.
What the fuck? No.
Now, if you said San Francisco, I would have said, okay, yeah.
Oh my god. Wow.
So all right, let's get down to business. Queenie comes out first. And Zombie, you can stop me if this isn't what actually happened. Queenie comes out of the brush first, and the Neko kind of eyes you, Queenie, with suspicion, but it just kind of like raises a paw to you and says, ho there. And then Zombie comes out, and if I understand this correctly, Zombie points at him and says, I want you as a pet.
Oh my god.
Is that what happened?
No.
I'm going to die. I'm going to die.
No, I retract that.
Okay, I'm just saying.
Now you see the error of your ways there, Zombie.
Yes!
Now, I will, like, if that was your final answer, I would have allowed it, because I'm prepared for that shit, too, but... But no, if you retract it, then it's retracted.
No, I don't want him as a pet, I want him as a companion. Will he be my friend?
I want like, you no, okay, if he says, like, I want to be your friend, I'm acceptable to that.
No, it's just, alright, oh, so here's his reaction to either of them, as long as you're not calling him a pet. Here's his reaction. The Neko Goblin immediately readies his bow, but isn't aiming it at you guys. He's just got it at the ground and says, meow, who goes there?
Oh, he's so cute with his little bow and those little meow voices.
Oh my god.
Who's that meow?
Oh my god.
Is this guy blind or something?
Oh no, the other two are in the bushes, or I guess the grass before they get to. God, I didn't think this through. You know what? Let's actually draw this out. Okay, so.
Oh lord.
So let's actually see what's going on here. Meow. What's going on?
Oh god.
I fall over in a fit of giggles.
Okay, so let's say we got the big crypt right here, right? And let's say around here you've got some walls with a nice little gate.
Meow.
And some more walls down here, and some more walls down here. And there's a lot of places to hide around tombstones if that was so your choice. And there's, yeah. So you guys are coming in from the north, and Queenie and Zombie, I imagine you're actually going through the front gates, and Meow Guy is right here with the M.
Okay.
So that's okay. This is the setup right now. Now,
hold on.
Where is everyone?
Okay,
that's Nordy. Now Nordy's over on the left. Nordy, you gotta pick one spot.
Sorry, being an idiot. So we got those two coming through the front gate.
Yeah.
Is this like a fence or something?
Is this a fence? Oh, it's sorry, it's a stone wall.
How high is that stone wall?
It's about waist high, but to the Nekos, it's head high. Like, if they walk behind that wall, you'd be able to see their pot, and that's it. The pot that's on their head.
I'm right there.
Your Queenie's right there.
Okay.
I'm right back here. No, don't do that! No!
Apparently,
Elisa's all over the place.
Apparently.
I'm sorry.
She's glitching out. I blame lag.
The wall, laying down, listening.
Okay.
I don't want this to go south, and it does. I'm gonna need to spring to action.
Okay, left or right of the wall. Over here or over here?
Right. I'm gonna be right here.
Okay. So we'll just
right where I'm gonna change my colors so we're not getting screwed up here.
No, this is fine. You're that little dot right there.
No, and it's the thing that me being red and you being red.
I'm darker red. You know what? I'll do it. Or be orange. I don't care.
That's what I was going for, was orange. What the hell? Orange. There.
He's in your head.
I'm right behind those two.
Hold on. How do I do that circle thingy?
I have no idea. I don't even know how you guys are making the squares.
Yet again, click and hold.
Oh, you're just clicking the little square thingy in the corner.
Oh, there's a draw shape option. Why the fuck have I not been doing this?
We don't know.
Man, that would have made drawing this church a lot easier. I mean, crypt.
Crypt, you mean dog? Crypt.
Oh god. I hope this isn't anything like the fight I had to do in Witcher the other day that took me 3 days.
No, this won't take 3 days. Either this goes south or it goes okay.
Because the guy I was fighting was hitting me with a broken shovel that took all his health back every time he hit me with it.
Oh, vampiric shovel. Cool.
That sounds amazing.
That is kind of awesome.
It was the most Dark Souls fight I've ever had in my life.
You know what? I have to ask. Just let me derail this game for a second, because I have to ask, how did he figure out that the shovel would give him life back? Because when I have a shovel, I don't often think
early on when every time I would hit him, he would hit me and he'd get all his health back.
I'm just trying to imagine.
Like, you health stealing son of a bitch.
I'm guessing it's like Black Blade. Of
Dark Souls play, so that isn't uncommon in games like that at all.
Well, I'm just trying to imagine this guy picking up a shovel and going, "This shovel will bleed others and give me life."
His name was, what was it? The Caretaker. That's what it was.
I am the caretaker. I'm going to take care of the crap out of you.
Really gnarly.
Okay, back to this game.
Sorry.
So, Queenie and Zombie are approaching. And I'll okay. Didn't expect to grab her name. So Queenie and Zombie are approach. Damn it. Queenie and Zombie are approach. Damn it. Queenie and Zombie. Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me?
Holy shit!
It's still going.
Yeah. Got knocked up. There we go. You deleted me!
The top to stop it.
Oh my god.
Good lord, stop confusing me, you two. Alright, Queenie and Zombie are approaching. Nordy is hiding underneath, and Eliza, you are just hanging back.
Well, I'll go forward behind them. Like, towards the into the entrance.
Okay, so the three. Oh my god, Eliza. All right, so you three are going forward. This isn't like a grid map battle system. That's not the way this game works. So, okay. The guard readies his bow and basically says, "Who goes there?" Queenie, you talking? Who's talking?
I'm talking.
Well, who goes there?
My name is Queenie. I'm from Poundtown. I saw two of my brethren running past and they dropped a bow.
He nods to the two humans behind you and is like, What's with the humans?
They're my traveling companions.
Hang on a second. I gotta think about this.
Okay. I would have went, they're my pets.
They're not smart. So let me just see something real quick here. I guess it'd be 2d4. Because that's...
Fucking zebra, man.
6.
Yeah. Yeah, he's smart enough to kind of figure this. Like, wait a second. You're with the humans. No humans here. He actually aims his bow at you at this point. It's like, no humans in this graveyard. This is our graveyard.
No, they're harmless. I just want to know who Top Cat is.
Top Cat? Top Cat is Top Cat. Meow, you get out of here. Right, meow.
I'm one of the city Konekos. I've never heard of Top Cat.
Oh, God. He rolls his eyes. Top Cat is Top Cat. He's the Top Cat.
Can I talk to the Top Cat?
Oh, I guess if you want to, but Top Cat's not here.
Where's Top Cat?
Top Cat's at... you're making me come up with shit on the fly. Fuck.
How do I play this?
Okay.
I don't think the cat said that.
Yeah, right?
He might have actually said that. No, it was like... Top Cat way over towards the setting sun. Or the setting moon. The setting pumpkin. You know what I mean.
So he's off to
the...
He's off to the west, then.
Yeah, he live in the highlands.
In the highlands?
Yeah. Okay. But we're working for Top Cat. And he like, you know, shoves out his chest. He's super proud that he's working for Top Cat. It's like, I'm the guard here. Nobody can pass by me. Because I'm doing this for Top Cat. Because Top Cat's awesome. He's got a hat. Not a pot. Can you believe it? And a monocle.
Oh, fuck. Oh, shit.
Oh, God.
Hey, you haven't seen Top Cat. You need to see Top Cat. Top Cat's to the west. Go to the west. He lives in the highlands above the human mind.
Above the human mind. Okay.
Can you show us?
Hell no. I gotta guard this crypt. And I can't let any humans know that we have all the bows here. Nobody's getting by me. Nobody will ever figure it out.
Are you sure he's like really say that?
Yes! Yes, okay. He's
right.
How many are actually guards for here? Is it just him?
How many people are here?
Is it just you guarding?
Oh, no! That would be ridiculous. If the humans found this place, then... I couldn't hold up all the humans off. That would be crazy. No, there's three others.
There's three others that are helping you?
Yeah! And
so Top Cat couldn't trust you alone?
But, I mean, yeah, of course he trusts me alone. I mean, I'm guarding the door, aren't I?
Then where are the other two?
Oh, they're downstairs counting the bows.
Oh, okay.
Jump them. Let's make this quick.
Oh, okay.
Hang on a second. He might indeed notice that you are whispering to him, so I'm just gonna make a quick roll here.
I'm not whispering this in game. I'm being sarcastic outside of game.
I'm gonna go with it because it's fucking hilarious. But no, he didn't notice nothing. He just kind of like. Confidentially, your friend sounds a little sick. He's a little hoarse. You should probably get him out of this rain.
Yeah, he didn't sleep all that well.
My eyes start.
Do you happen to have any water on you?
Hmm.
I hear what Nordy whispers and my eye starts twitching.
Just so he can have a little bit of water, help his voice.
Yeah, sure. Come on in. Just you.
But, no problem, no problem.
So, okay.
I make a motion with my tail to have them, like, follow just very quietly.
This has become a very strange game of Mission Impossible.
Right?
Okay. Queenie, it's just a set of sounds. It's actually really, like, if this were a D&D dungeon, it would be the shortest D&D dungeon.
Well, yeah, it's a crypt.
Yeah, it's not like some advanced super crypt. It's just a set of stairs that goes down and branches into two rooms. One room clearly is where they've been sleeping and has their supplies, and that's where he's taking you. And you can clearly see in the other room they've got, like, a couple of bows set up against the walls. The bows that they just stole are set up against the wall. What's everybody else doing?
I'm following
quietly.
Sneaking in, like...
Yeah, I want to kind of sneak up and start taking people out.
Okay, hang on. It's just, to clarify here, it is just Queenie inside the crypt right now.
Yes.
For now, I'm giving you guys a chance to sneak behind.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I mean, they're Neko-Goblins. No. They're not real smart.
No, I'm just gonna sneak up and just stand, like, on the corner, like, like,
yeah,
right,
yeah. Show me
on
the map.
Door.
Show me on the map. Like, are you actually
like, okay? Like, I'm coming. Okay, I'm about to draw something very stupid here.
Cool. Stupid is what we do best, dude.
I'm sneaking. Right? While they're going inside, I am sneaking.
You're basically going to block the only entrance.
No, I'm going over. I'm going over here and standing beside the door. And waiting for the Captain Cat the. For the two of them to come out and the door to shut. Okay. And they want to jump him when he gets out.
Okay, I will clarify the scene for you real quick. This crypt has no door. It's just a stone. This is what it looks like, right? Yeah, it's like it's just a set of steps that goes downwards about one level down and then branches off into two rooms where there are coffins. Right.
I know, but you said, but when I hear crypt, I'm talking, I think of building with a
door. The door's probably broken off.
Yeah.
There's no door. I'm talking like, let's say that this is the, the fixture we're looking at is the front. You got the alcove door here.
Mm-hmm.
Hang on. Freehand. This is the entrance. Blah, blah, blah. Freehand fucking sucks. I'm going to stand on this side.
Okay.
And wait for them.
Just
and,
out of view.
You're standing on the side of the doorway just in case. Okay. So you can trip people as they leave. Awesome.
Yeah, basically, he's going to walk out and I'm just going to step behind. It's like, hi.
All right. So that's Nordy. Zombie, Elisa, are you sneaking in behind Queenie?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. You see the same thing that Queenie does. Are you guys actually making any attempt to sneak?
Oh, yeah, I was just going to ask if I should roll a stealth check.
Yeah, if you are, roll a stealth check. These guys aren't too bright, so you just don't, you know, roll okay. Actually, I'm going to take a look at my little table here. Yeah, just roll over. Oh, my God! Okay, first off...
I thought
I'm
the stairs.
So.
Zombie!
So, okay, first off, and yes, zombie, that is what you do. First off, everybody gets a fumble point.
Another one?
Yes, everybody gets a fumble point. Now, remember, you can trade these in before you make a roll to get a plus one to your roll.
God damn it.
Fumble points are good. So I'm going to be ready to run on in there and go. Let's go, boy.
Zombie, do you have any armor? Are you carrying anything with you?
Yeah.
probably just his knives and what clothes he's got on his back.
Okay, so here's what happens. Queenie, you just walk in. You're a fellow cat. They accept you as a fellow cat. You don't have the same skull painting, so they also realize you're not the same tribe, but for the most part, it's not a problem. Elisa, you sneak in. You're fine. You're quiet. Just tip-tapping in there. Nobody sees you. Nobody hears you.
Leroy Jenkins!
Zombie, you try to sneak in, and as soon as you step into the doorway, you don't... The steps are a lot steeper than you think, and your foot just sort of slips, causing you to fall down. But you catch yourself on the wall after the first hit until your pack hits you and causes you to fall down some more. And that causes your leg to catch into one of the little torch grips. I don't know what they're called. And that falls out and falls on you. And so you are just... This continues on as you go downstairs very slowly. It hurts, but I'm not going to let you lose any hit points to this. Because instead what happens is you make such a massive clatter that just goes on and on. Clatter, 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 bang, clatter, clatter, oof, ouch, oof, oof, clatter, cling, bang. And slowly all of the Nekos are exiting their... All four of the Nekos and Queenie and Elijah are all turning around to see you, to see what this terrible noise is. They don't even have to move fast. They're just like, huh. Even the four Nekos are looking like, huh. And one of them's just like, got its paw over its mouth like, oh my god, poor guy.
That would be me, like, oh fuck.
And finally, you hit the ground and say, I'm sneaky. Actually, I'll leave it up to you if you say that, but it's just, I imagine what you would say.
Why, hold on, Racket, we're trying to sneak up on these guys. Hello.
What hey, governor.
Oh, God.
One of the Nekos yells, two arms!
Jesus, no, no!
Oh, shit.
And I'm trying not to horse laugh from outside of the
room. Yeah, Nordy, even you had to peek in to see, what the hell?
Yeah, it's like, yeah, they just seem like my head's just peeking, like, what the fuck?
Oh, God, no.
Well, this is why we can't have nice things, guys.
Okay. So let me do a little things on here. We don't need this guy right here. And let me go ahead and pull you guys over to the battle map.
Oh, Jesus.
Now,
why are there four?
Yep, gotta have them.
I thought you said there were three.
No, I said there were three others.
Yeah, there's three others guarding.
Oh.
The main one and the three others guarding.
I always thought there were two, but okay, never mind.
Okay, C and D are in the side room, we'll just say. A is the guy. Oh my god, what happened to you, A? You lost your middle bit.
There we go. That almost turned into a Greek letter there for a second.
Oh my god, D. There you go, buddy.
D
lost his rigidity. It went limp.
Nobody picked the D tonight.
Now, here's the gimmick. All right, here's the gimmick to this fight. Queenie, you are right here.
Oh, God, help me.
Wait, where's she? Oh, I can barely...
Actually, I'm going to say you're on the front line right over here.
Hold on.
Because A, we'll call him Alpha, Kitty Alpha, puts a paw behind you and is like, get behind me, little one. Humans are here. All right.
Oh, shit.
Now, I'm going to call that front line if you want to attack them, Queenie, so it would act like you're actually on the other side. But if you want to do some covert shit, I'll let you do that. All right.
I might have to.
So, okay, front area and back area. Who's where?
I think I'm your bone robot.
Yeah, Nordy, yep. You're in the back area because you were still waiting at the door.
Yeah, I know that, man, but you're going robot. I can barely understand what you're saying.
Oh, crap. Sorry.
Okay, there we go. You're fine now.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm in the back. That's mm-hmm. okay with me.
Where am I?
I guess you're in the front. And Zombie is definitely in the front.
I'm right behind Zombie, still trying to hide.
She's hiding behind me.
They can see you. They can see Larissa.
I know. Damn it.
Even if you said, you can't see me, they are stupid, but they're still cats. They can see you, even in the dark.
What, I don't have the force that I can tell people they didn't see me?
Not yet. You're going to have to get to at least level 5, and then we'll start talking about it.
Nothing. Okay.
Okay, so I need to ask, who is the leader of this group now that... oh, wait, Nordy, you're the leader of the group.
Surprise, motherfucker.
Yeah, I forgot. All right,
yeah,
well...
that was Saturday I couldn't join because I was going to be working. But today's Sunday. I'm off. Yay.
All right.
Eat potatoes.
Okay. Elisa, give me an object that's in here.
I just dropped a lot of them.
He's not wrong. Pick up the wooden utensils. The backpack. Shove one in there for interrogation.
Oh, like inside the crypt?
Yeah, inside the crypt where the battle is happening. Give me an object that would be around here that you could use to your advantage.
By a torch.
Lit or non-lit?
A lit torch.
Smoke weed every day.
Okay. Lit torch.
I'm sorry, I asked for lit or non-lit.
Queenie, give me another item.
I'm always lit.
Oh. I would say one of the bows.
All right.
She's not wrong.
Loose bow. All right, Nordy, give me an item.
Oil.
Oil? What, like lamp oil?
Lamp oil. You gotta use something to light the torches with.
This is true.
All right.
If it lamp oil set fire.
Zombie, give me an item.
My teeth.
Zombies, teeth. Now remember, other people can use these items too. All right, Eliza, give me one last item.
I locked out a couple.
Rocks on the ground.
Okay.
These rocks.
Stones. Got it.
Stones.
Okay, everybody roll initiative.
Okay, hang on. What did I do with my roll checks and shit?
I believe it's like...
That was awful.
Please tell me I have combat labeled off here. Weapons, enemy classes, magic, terrain, NPC. No, of course I don't. I need to tab that off. Okay. Okay, I need to mark this, I guess. Because I don't have it marked. Fuck. Okay.
I'm just having no good rolls tonight.
So, neither am I. I got a 3 also.
Let me roll initiative.
As near as I can tell, you cannot fumble initiative. I might be wrong. I don't think you can.
All right. What about the Neko? What about the Nekos here, mate?
They have an initiative of 6.
Of 6. So it's gonna go me,
all 4 Nekos, Queenie, and then me and Elisa.
Yeah. It's gonna Elisa and Zombie.
It doesn't matter either way.
Yeah, you gotta go at the same time.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. I guess Nordy, you're first?
Yeah.
And I am going to keep track of their health real quick.
Alright, so Queenie is in the forward line, A and B. I'm in the back area. What can I do in the back area?
You can throw stuff at the... Actually, what weapon do you have? I can't remember.
I have a trident.
You have a trident? Okay. You can do support things for the group, and you can run to the front area.
Can I pick up a bow where I'm at?
No, it's okay. I'm gonna say it's over in the front area because you were way back at the top of the stairs.
Can I pick up the lamp oil and run into front area? But not use said lamp oil, just have it in hand?
Well, the way the objects work is you use the objects as you're attacking.
I'm just going to front area.
Okay.
I'll just move my happy ass up here.
Whoop. Wonder what happens if two people delete something at the same time. I have to know.
Divide by zero?
I have to know. Norty, right. you and me, we have to delete these squares at the same time. Ready?
I can't select it.
Oh, you can't?
Yeah, I can't select it.
You can only delete it.
Interesting.
Yeah, let's try it with something that I draw, okay? Because I think because you're GM, your stuff I can't remove. However, you can remove the shit that I put down.
Okay, on three. One, two.
Let me highlight it first.
Okay, ready? One, two, three.
Okay, yeah. I guess it's whoever hits delete first.
Huh, all right. Sorry about that. I needed to experiment. Let's see here.
Oh, it can be.
Yeah, that's...
Nekos, ting ting.
Nekos, yes. Okay, the Nekos go first. They are all armed with bows. So...
This is gonna hurt.
Just a bit.
End up a guard in Whiterun. Just an arrow to the knee.
Okay. First person they're going to attack is going to be...
Probably the idiot who made all the fucking noises.
Right?
Yeah. Alpha is like, I knew you were no good humans. And let me roll to hit, which is...
All I've got to do is plant the seed for
zombie
stab.
I'm just going to make that a macro real quick. Actually, can you make these macros, I wonder? I'll have to mess with this later. Until then, I'll just do this.
Who's joined us?
Ice back.
Pyro's back.
Oh.
Okay.
You don't have to sound so disappointed.
Zombie, you are hit.
I see.
What? Wait, what happened to me? Why am I away? Why am I not here?
Oh no, you're gone, honey.
Okay, I'm rejoining. Give me a second.
Yeah, I think it kicked him again.
Of course, I have a big ass bag of dice over there now. I can just grab a D6 and. Okay, there we go. Sorry about that. Okay, zombie, you take 3 damage.
Me.
Okay.
All right, beta is working. Beta is going to attack Eliza. And what is your... You're a 3?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it hits you too.
Damn.
Hate you long time, zombie.
Love you.
Okay, you take 3 damage as well, Eliza. C is going to go after Norty. Because you just saw somebody run down the stairs. Does not hit.
It wolf. Not like it would hurt me anyway.
Well, they are... I mean, they're actually pretty good with bows. And a throwback at zombie. Zombie is hit. You guys might think about redoing your situation, right? And that's 6 damage.
Shit!
Oh, damn!
How are you doing, zombie?
Took an arrow to the dick.
Took an arrow to the dick is right.
Oh.
So, okay.
Ladies, you know, this is what I like to call a Prince Albert.
I'm at 7 hit points out of 16. I'm bleeding a bit.
Nice Prince Albert.
So, okay.
No, that wasn't an Albert. That was an Apollong.
Oh. Wow.
I didn't think these guys would hurt so much.
Don't ask me why I know that.
Zombie's gonna die!
No, zombie might downstairs.
Well, yeah, because he fell down the stairs and took damage doing that. Damn!
No, he did. He got, remember, he got the butt touch. And that butt touch healed him.
Yeah, no, I healed him for that, but no, ruining the sneak ruined it.
Yeah, the good news is that 0 hit points is not dead in this game. You have to go your condition below 0 in order to die in this game.
My condition below 0?
Yeah.
Yeah, what's your condition roll?
5.
Okay, so just don't take 5 more damage over under 0. Don't go to -5 hit points.
Well, I'm at 7
right
now.
Can I back up and then cast my double heal spell again?
On your turn, you can do stuff.
Okay, I just was wondering.
All right, and you will be able to do one or the other. Run upstairs or cast heal. Okay, Queenie, you're up. And keep in mind, if you guys are in dire straits, you do have fumble points. Every single one of you, including Zombie.
But I don't care what those are.
Okay, here's how those work. Before you roll attack, for example, you can spend a fumble point and get a +1 to your attack.
Kind of like a concentration?
That's exactly what it is. It's concentration.
But it doesn't cost half your mana.
No, it doesn't cost half your mana. You can do that as well and get an additional +1. And of course, you could use an object and explain to me how you use it, and get a +3 total, which is kind of ridiculous. That's more than what you'd need to hit them.
Okay, situation, honestly, to me, is not looking all that great. Alright, no, I'm gonna have to do... the rooms... Are we in the hallway, or...
You're all in the hallway, yeah.
Even better. Okay, no, just listen to me. Listen, I gotta.
C and D are in the doorways of other rooms. A, B, and you, Queenie, are all in the hallway. Let's call them Alfred and Betty, Alfred Cat and Betty Cat and Charlie Cat and Dave. Demon Cat.
No, Dave.
Okay.
Wait, what is this big box?
That's the hallway. I'll wait till he's done. Kind of making it for us, so.
It's 8-bit penis.
Whoops, I didn't mean to do that, sorry.
You're fine. But you see, I did that for like visual purposes.
That's fine. It works out fine.
Yeah.
But wait, then how did C and D hit us if they're in the room?
They're in the doorway.
What was that? You're roboting.
They're in the doorway.
Am I roboting?
Just a little bit.
Just a wee bit there, laddie.
I'm having trouble with my connection tonight. I'm sorry.
We had a storm earlier, so it's a little wonky. Sorry, guys.
1-800 shit
happens. Okay, so we are in a tight corridor.
Mm-hmm.
I want to try and give my guys a way to get out.
Okay, what are you thinking?
Falling leaves.
I don't remember what falling leaves does.
They drop the cubic meter of dead leaves. And it stays.
Oh my god, a cubic meter. Okay, if you want to do this, I'm going to say that you can...
I just touch the ground and boom, it's there.
What is it, fall magic?
It is fall magic, yes.
Interesting. Range touch. Cubic meters of dead leaves appear. What's your plan?
I basically just say, I come up behind, I guess, A. Shit. And I don't know, no one is going to get this joke except for my husband. How come it's a house of leaves?
Everybody's going to get that joke. People know what House of Leaves is.
Maybe. I actually don't.
See? And I have to roll.
Okay. Let's try it. And I'm going to say if... Just roll your sense check. Let's see what you do.
Okay, hold on. Or my... Yeah, my magic check.
Yeah, do your magic check, and I'm going to rate it. So roll high.
I'm going
to
try.
What if I don't have permission to put into Gothage?
That's...
Six?
Yeah, does it do anything? Because it doesn't really do any damage.
No, it doesn't do anything, but I'm gonna...
That's okay. Weird. You should have access to Gothage.
What the... Why don't you have access to Gothage?
I don't.
No.
You're gonna have to talk to a wall about that, because you need to get under the Gothage Discord.
That's what everyone...
Wait a minute, the fuck?
Hi.
Okay.
No,
what's the problem, Queenie?
I'm a mod.
So add him to Gothage.
I'm gonna have to figure out how to do that.
How are you, my question is, how did you get mod status?
The fuck if I know.
I don't know. Well, when you get a chance, subtract 2 MP from your magic. Yeah. So, here's what happens. What's the magic word you were using?
How come it's a house of leaves?
How come it's a house of leaves?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can someone explain this to me now?
It's an in joke. A house of leaves is a book.
It's also part of Poe, if you ever check out the album Haunted. It's really good.
No idea what that is either.
Yeah. I'll link you, don't worry.
Okay.
Alright, let me figure this out. No, it says you can come in here.
Okay.
Oh, maybe not.
So, here's what happens. Yeah, this is what happens. First off, combat is off.
Oh!
Why is combat off?
I'll explain. Zombie, Elisa, Nordy, you just see, like, after she says, how come it's a house of leaves, you just see a pile of leaves seem to clip through the ceiling and just foomp, land, separating you and all of the Nekos from each other. So now there's this gigantic pile of leaves.
Alright, go ahead and try to get in Gothage real fast. Morty, I think I got you.
Queenie?
Yes?
You are now on the other side of the, of the hallway. There's this gigantic wall of leaves completely blocking the way. And, yeah, you can't see outside. However, it's like there's one, maybe one torch in the back room of the supply room. But even without that, you and your brethren can see very clearly, oh, there's a whole bunch of leaves here. And B, being right next to it, is kind of confused and sort of lifts his paw up above his head and sort of bats at it. Alfred Cat kind of stares at you. Nobody else, it's like everybody else is, where did these meow, where did these leaves come from? It's like, did the humans do this? Huh. Only Alfred Cat is like staring right at you, eyes wide.
Oh God.
What do you do? Actually, yeah. What is, because Queenie, that was your move. What is everybody else doing?
Well, there goes my plan.
Why? What was your plan?
I was gonna chuck some oil at one of those guys and set them on fire. Can't now. Can't damage the product.
I'm still bleeding from several orifices.
Cast my double cure on.
Not just several orifices, new orifices, brand new orifices.
I put my hands together a lot this time, and I knock him over for being a dumbass.
All right, roll your magic, and it's gonna take 6 MP to do.
Touch my butt. Touch it nice.
Not being nice, dumbass. Oh!
Okay.
That's gonna leave a nice handprint.
Roll 3d6.
Yes, that is.
And then roll what?
Roll 3d6. You just did a crit on your Cure Touch, and the other one adds an additional die. So that's double dice for Cure Touch 17. Plus 17. That should fully heal you, zombie.
It does.
Nice.
That's
more
than what my
zombie, you like. See the light when she touches your butt. Just like, God, is that you?
It's me, zombie.
And won't lie, you got a little bit of a stiffy. Little bit of a stiffy.
He's got a thumb.
So.
A little bit of a stiffy going on there.
Okay, well, that's going on. Nordy, what are you doing?
I'm just kind of staring at the leaves, like, and I just say, well, fuck.
That's. You're. Okay.
Like, it's like, that doesn't take up my thing, but I'm just. Okay, so I guess I'll just go wading into the leaves. And just start poking shit.
Poke the right shit.
Okay,
probably not. That's not probably not the best thing to do. I'm just gonna shout out, like, okay, it looks like we've got a problem here. No, zombie. No.
No.
Like the leaves on fire.
I'm sorry, but we need to keep. We set the leaves on fire. We set the bows on fire. We set the bows on fire. We don't get any money.
No. And if you set me on fire, you have to answer to the wrath of Wall.
And also, we'll probably set Queenie on fire too, which won't be that great either.
Yeah, no.
Cat on fire.
That might be a little bit of trouble. So, all right, Queenie, I'm going to give you a little bit of chime before the leaves start parting and the battle begins again. Everybody is now in front row, first off. So let me move Charlie Cat in front row. And there we go. Yeah.
So I take it I can't see shit?
Nobody can see anything except for Queenie right now. You can't see what's on the other side of the leaves. Darn it, Demon Cat.
It's Dave.
Oh, and I'm also out of mana.
Hey, Goal Hunter. You're looking at Ryutama. Sorry, somebody on my stream. So, all right. Don't get any
you're
of the money. No
the frat boy version of D&D.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
So I'm out of mana now, right?
I guess so. You've been spending it on zombie all day.
Hey, it's not my fault he can't keep himself healed.
No, I keep myself healed. I just keep tripping.
Learn to sneak.
I'm not
wrong.
I can't.
This is why we can't have nice things.
So Queenie, you got a little bit of time before everything starts up. Any plan? What are you doing?
Oh, God. I was hoping. Hold on.
I will say that Alfred Cat is looking at you and is like. Is kind of pointing at you with his paw and is trying to work things out and is saying, like. This is.
How she can be.
Cats can't do magic.
I learned magic.
Oh.
That, yeah. Okay.
Okay. Now all the other cats turn slowly at you. What?
Meow.
Yeah, we know magic. I know magic.
Oh, the only top cat knows magic.
No, way. I know magic.
Oh, cats don't do. Like they're all still in awe, and then a trident pokes out from the leaves.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Oh!
It pokes out for the butt.
So, oh, shall we start again?
Please, I'd like to get shit underway.
All right, new item that I'm throwing, a sixth item that I'm throwing in here. Leaves. So.
Oh, dear Lord.
Because of the situation, and now that all of the other Nekos are really not trusting you, Queenie, I'm going to put you, just for the sake of keeping track of things, you are now in the front area, and you're with the humans, and they know. So, everybody roll initiative.
Oh, God. Yep.
Yep. Trust me, you want to roll initiative again anyway. I'm giving you a boon. Actually, Queenie gave you a boon.
Damn, I'm going to rewrite all this.
Queenie allowed you to re-roll initiative, and you guys wanted to re-roll initiative.
Damn it. That puts me in a shit storm of a...
No, you're actually doing okay, Nordy. No, God, everybody's doing a lot better, except for Queenie, who's with the cats.
Hang on. No, I have to rewrite this all down. That's what I don't like about it.
Oh. Yeah, I'm doing that, too. I'll give you a second. It's all right.
Me.
I go last, yeah.
Queen
on shit
bags.
I go first.
I go second.
Stab. You guys can't even see shit right now.
No, we can see shit.
Okay.
From what I understood. I'm assuming I can. You know what they say about assuming.
You may need to ask that of you and being the merciless.
Can't make an ass out of me, I do that enough.
He's got a point there.
Right? It's my drink. My shawl is too short, guys. It's too short.
Actually, do hob Nekos do god magic, I wonder? I've never actually looked it up.
God magic? I am god. Bow to me.
No, if they've got magic.
Oh, goth. Oh.
Goth magic. No. Nekos can't do magic, so...
Huh.
Queenie must be special.
Well, she's a city cat, I guess. It is weird, though. You're a cat that can do magic. That's not...
There's not a lot of us, yeah. And it was... Ha, kid!
So we're all on the same side of the room now, right?
Yeah, we're all on the same side of the room.
I got forked over.
Okay.
You hightailed it when they started getting wary of. You're with them.
Yeah. So, okay. After the trident sort of pushes apart all of the leaves and the whole thing starts up, all the objects are still there with an additional object of leaves. The Nekos kind of move on the other side of you, Queenie, before combat starts. And first one is Zombie?
No, it's Alyssa.
Larissa? All right.
So, just out of curiosity, there's a defined separation between us on our side with the leaves and them on theirs, right?
I'm going to say that the trident kind of knocked all the leaves down so that everything is at knee level.
Okay.
But everybody is now on a level playing field.
Cool. Let's kill shit.
Okay, well, then I'm just going to go after A with my sword.
Okay. Roll the hit. Are you guys gonna hoard fumble points, by the way? I just need to know. You can. You can absolutely do that. That's fine.
What is it?
I'm hoarding them. I'm saving it for when something really stupid happens. Like, yeah, this is a dragon. You gotta fight it. To hit.
Is it hunting that I have to roll?
No, you roll to hit.
It's your accuracy underneath your weapon. In your inventory.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot. Thank you.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Like, I don't use it, so I don't know.
So
11.
Ooh, that's
okay,
not
that's
bad.
That's an absolute hit. Roll damage.
Now you gotta roll for damage.
Right.
4?
Finally.
An alpha? Okay. Okay. How did you stab him? Overhead, underhead? Were you doing like something from Brawlhalla?
Yeah, I went double-handed, like dual-handed right on its head.
Its pot blocks, but it still does it plenty of damage. And it just kind of topples backwards, like, Okay, zombies next.
Yeah, zombies now next.
Is it stabbing time?
It better be stabbing time.
What? What's the plus one for, by the way?
Because I had double blade.
Oh, shit, I keep forgetting that you did that. No, alright, you're fine. Okay, that's an absolute hit. So roll damage.
Who's he going after, though?
Yeah, actually, that's a good question. Who are you attacking?
I'm going after A.
Okay, so everybody's going after Alfred Cat.
Salt the wounds.
Biggest foe.
Where are you stabbing him? No, let me guess. The face?
Well, no, you said he fell back on his back, right?
No, none of them did. They're all on their paws. Feet.
Oh. Wait, are they standing on 4 feet or 2 feet?
2 feet.
2 feet.
Okay, thank you.
You stab him in the belly?
In the belly.
Okay. He slightly, like, curves to the side, but you cut him real bad. And he's like, oh, it makes me feel like a man, but it still hurts. Yeah. Anyway. Meow. And, He's still standing. Who's next? Nordy. Okay.
I want to go for B. I'm going in like I'm taking a pitchfork to a bale of hay. I'm stabbing him right in the gut and going straight up.
Okay.
Going in dry.
Yeah, he is.
Hi.
Oh, damn. Nice.
Damn.
Oh, you did a crit hit. Oh, hi. That's a little more. Okay.
What happened to my bow?
What do they use? It uses strength, right?
Yeah, that's my shit. And I get a plus one because it's a trident or a polearm.
Okay.
Oh my.
So, okay, what is your strength right now? Eight! Whoa, pretty nifty.
You're changing. Okay, you're moving my shit around because I'm staring at my journal and it's fucking me up. So.
I did not mean to do that. I didn't even realize that was happening. Sorry.
Yeah, because I went from all inventory to stats. It's like, what the fuck? My hands off my mouse.
It's possessed.
Ghost.
Yeah.
Spooky ghost.
I should do this, bub.
Okay. Roll 2d8 plus 1.
Okay, how do I do that?
You type in / roll space 2d8 plus 1.
Roll 2d8. All one word?
Yeah, 2d8 plus 1, all one word.
Nice.
He dead. So here's what happens. So here's what happens. You start off low like you're baling hay, right? He figures you're gonna go for his feet, so he jumps in the air, and then you do the hay lift through the leaves and smack him right in the
stomach.
Yeah, okay, you smack him right in the stomach. And he's like, ah, and he's kicking and kicking and kicking and finally just falls limp.
I'm gonna turn you into my new meat bicycle!
Meat bicycle. What does that even mean?
Do you really want to know?
I don't think we do. Really.
Kinda. I kinda do.
Sorry, that was just me getting a little bit excited.
He's letting his anger out. Bend over, nobody's going in dry. Yes. Yeah.
Meanwhile, the other cats are looking in horror like, Queenie, you're up.
Oh, God.
Now, whatever you do is going to happen at the same time as the other three. So even if you kill one of them, he gets a shot off before he dies.
I know. I'm looking for my bow. My bow disappeared.
You have so many bows around you.
No, my crossbow. All my stuff disappeared. I'm trying to find it unless it updated or something. I can't find it anywhere.
Baby, it's...
Yeah?
Hang on. Let me take a look at your sheet.
Baby, come back.
Your crossbow is under class.
Your class?
Yes.
Where do I roll for it, honey?
Isn't it under bow? Wait, why?
Inventory.
Yeah.
Why is her under inventory? Oh, it is under inventory.
Yeah, it's under weapons.
All weapons are under inventory.
Okay.
Just gonna change her size real quick.
Pyro, you'll be happy for this. I named it a foxy bow.
Woo!
Oh, is Pyro still listening?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh yeah, he's here.
I dropped in and out about 5 times because I had to restart twice to get Fallout 4 to load.
Alright, does D have a pot on his head?
D does indeed have a pot on his head. They all have pots, except for Top
Cat. I'm aiming for D's pot on his head.
Alright.
Because as you know, if their pot knocks over, they have to stop any whatever they're doing to get their shit.
Oh my god, that's right. Alright, I'll allow it. I'm going to give you a slight penalty, but not a big one. Go ahead and try and roll.
I rolled.
That's not a hit. That's not even a hit. Yeah. While you're aiming for the pot, and it not only does it miss, it hits the ceiling and drops into the pot.
Fuck.
Go!
Nordy, leave the only person on my Twitch alone. I guess you're on my Twitch as well, huh?
I am.
So, no, that didn't do anything. Okay, A fears for A's life. So A is running towards, I don't know, this side. Sure, why not? So he's in the back row. C is, I need to remember what their accuracy is. There it is.
Wait, what? What is A trying to run away?
No, A's not running away. A can't run away. He'd have to go through you guys. But he's backing up because he doesn't want to die today.
Like his buddy who's still on my trident.
Oh, good God.
Because right now my trident is like resting on the ground, spikes up, and it's just kind of laying there limp.
And bloody.
Okay. Charlie Cat is going after Larissa and does not hit. And Demon Cat is like looking up at the arrow that just fell into his pot. He takes it out, he draws it, and he aims it at Queenie. And it does not hit.
Oh, cool! I can see the dice.
Oh, dude, how'd you do the dice thing? That's
pretty
epic.
So is it my turn again?
I went under settings and turned on 3D dice.
Oh, dude, I gotta do that. That's pretty cool.
And Dragon Zombie says, knife dick.
Knife dick.
Sure, alright.
Okay, so I'm gonna go after C, because they went after me. With my sword.
Okay. Charlie Cat's ready for you, whatever you got. Charlie Cat laughs or even purrs as he just kind of pulls to the side. Charlie Cat isn't afraid of you.
Well, he didn't get me either, so.
Hey, buddy, how you doing?
Oh,
God.
Charlie Cat, start preparing my blade for stabbing.
Yes!
Okay, going to my shit, adding myself a fumble point.
So, everybody gets a fumble point.
Zombie!
This is the third. So,
can we bring you again?
What happens when you fumble? What happens when you attack and fumble? Give me a second. Oh, I remember what happens when you attack and fumble.
Zombie, you okay, fam?
Okay, Zombie, your blade takes 1 damage, so it's now at a durability of 2 instead of 3.
No.
My durability goes out. One.
Oh shit!
Wait, what?
Damn sword!
I thought. Wait, no, no. Daggers have a start with a durability of at least two.
Yeah, you never told me to change the durability on it.
Well, I am now. Your durability is two.
Okay.
It wasn't a used knife, right? It was just a regular knife.
Yeah, I just bought it.
Yeah, so it should be a durability of two. God, you have me looking up everything. Everything!
Yeah, mine's a durability of one size.
Yeah, light blade. Oh, light blade, size one. It break.
Oh, fuck.
So, well, I got good and bad news for you. The bad news is you're now fighting with your hands. So here's what happens.
Oh, God.
And is that actually what happens in this accuracy check?
Can he talk that?
No, all it says that happens is that your weapon takes a durability hit. As far as I can tell. So yeah, it broke. Here's what happens, zombie. You're going in for the kill on which one? Charlie Cat or Demon Cat?
Charlie.
Charlie Cat? Okay, so Charlie Cat dodges to the side, just kind of moves his stomach to the side so that Eliza's sword passes by, and he sees your dagger heading straight for his face. And Charlie Cat, who's a smooth operator, grabs his pot, lowers it down, and headbutts his pot into your dagger, which causes your dagger to deflect and snap at the handle.
Oh, God.
Also, if you're in Pound Town next time, you might want to beat up the guy that sold you this dagger.
Right?
Because it snapped off at the handle, man. The handle! Shit. So
that's some shoddy workmanship, bro.
Hell yeah.
So the good news is they have weapons in this place. So you might be able to find something to defend yourself until then.
Cough, cough. Maybe your own teeth that are lying on the ground over there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, zombie, you're kind of taking the hits today, aren't you? Sorry about that, man.
He's the bitch tonight.
If we survive this, I'm going to try and take those teeth and turn them into a necklace.
I'll allow it. All right.
Yes, I'm doing it.
So, you might get Walrus to do it for you, but...
Oh my god, yes.
Oh,
okay.
Man. If I can get Walrus to make me a necklace out of demon's teeth, that's going to be a story to tell for when we finally meet Blade.
Oh my god, he probably wants those teeth for himself.
I guess right? Who's Nordy?
He's
you're next.
There.
Okay, zombie wants. Yeah, so it's me.
Okay,
hi, Charlie.
So Charlie Cat's looking really smug. Demon Cat's at the point now where he's just kind of sitting back and going, what? And Alfred Cat is bleeding from the gut and is just slagging against the doorway going, Top Cat, save us!
I hope he dies.
He will.
Whoa, what the hell just happened?
I don't know. Wait.
Hang on.
Did something go wonky?
Is everything wonky? Whoa, hey! We have dice!
Hey. Okay,
and that's not a good roll.
I know, that's weird. That screwed me up. I'm turning off the 3D dice. That confused the piss out of me.
Alright.
Oh, wait. Automatically roll 3D dice. Got it.
Wait, is that something that you can turn on? I want to do that. Oh my god, it does! Fuck yeah. Alright, I just turned that on. So I'm good.
Alright. I want to see what that does here now. Hang on.
Hey, that's much more. That's a lot handier. Cool.
I like the sound it makes, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that 10.
Okay, since we didn't know what we were going with,
Mulligan?
Yeah, I'm going to give you a mulligan. Actually roll the dice trying to hit this time.
Alright.
Instead of experimenting.
Okay. What the fuck?!
That a miss. Well, to be fair, it's the exact same thing you rolled like two rolls ago when you.
I know, which is fucking dumb.
So
that shit off.
That's RNGesus for you, man.
No, I blame the 3D rolling shit. Fuck that.
All right, well, turn it off. I don't care.
I did.
In either case,
we missed.
You miss because the tip of your spear is heavy with a dead cat. So,
and it gets, can you please tell me it gets slung off after I sling it?
Yeah, you like jab it forward at Charlie Cat, and Charlie Cat dodges out of the way of his dead friend going underneath his feet. Charlie Cat again is feeling pretty smug.
That wasn't meant to kill you.
Queenie Chan, you're up.
Oh god. Alright. I guess I wanna try to knock down Charlie Cat's pot again.
Oh, you were doing Demon Cat before, but yeah, whatever.
Oh, I was doing Demon Cat? Okay, well I'll just
doesn't matter.
He's being a smug little bastard.
What's the plus two for? Oh, because you're using a bow. It's a minus two. Four, six, five. Miss.
God damn it!
And which one were you going after again? Charlie Cat or Demon Cat?
Charlie Cat.
Charlie Cat is just like dancing now. He's like popping, locking, and just dodging all of these. He's like, yeah!
Grim.
Yeah.
I thought you were ignoring all of the third ones, the conditions.
What conditions?
No. Mine has one. Because mine's a two-handed crossbow.
Okay.
And the bows in general get a minus two to hit. That's why none of the cats have been able to hit you now that you've re-rolled initiative.
Okay.
Because your initiative is your two hit in this game.
Yeah.
Okay,
so.
Damn it.
Demon Cat is just kind of watching all of this and is just like, what the okay, and just kind of shoots. And he's going after the guy who had his friend at the end of his spear, Nordy.
Oh, geez.
Hey, Nordy, duck.
That's okay, it's not a crit, but that's pretty low. That's pretty low. You don't have anything to worry about, Nordy. There's an arrow sticking in the ceiling now, though.
No, that's fine. It wouldn't have hurt me anyway.
Charlie Cat is just like, ha ha ha, you can't touch me, meow. Nobody can touch me, but I can touch you. And he takes his bow and he shoots it at Queenie.
No!
And
shoot her in the face.
When Queenie, what is you? Yeah, it hits.
Oh god dang it.
Take one damage.
Oh thank god. Where is my damage? There it is. That's my health.
Sir Charlie Cat's like, haha, I'll knock your head off of your head, and it just kind of swishes by your ear and like, oh my god, my poor ear. Is it okay? Is it still there? Yeah, it's still there. So you're getting shock damage from almost losing an ear.
Yeah.
Is it my turn?
No, the
Alpha Cat is going to shoot.
How?
Well, he's got a bow. They all have bows.
But isn't he bleeding to death in the corner?
Yeah, that doesn't affect his aim. Not in this game.
Obviously, he's never been bleeding to death.
He is bleeding out pretty bad, but he can still hold a bow. And he realized by, at this point, Alfred Cadden is like, I'm not going to die today, and has nowhere to run, too. So.
If I die, I'm taking one of y'all with me.
Pretty much.
Oh, Jesus, not one of them.
No. And he's aiming at, I don't know, zombie.
Oh, Jesus!
Oh, wow. Zombie, what is your... Oh, no, it doesn't hit. It was real close, zombie, though. It was real close. It knocked your handle out of your hand.
Shit. Made me drop my booze.
Also, point of interest is I actually pasted and almost chatted the roll formula just now. Awesome. So whose turn is it now? It is Larissa's.
Yes.
Okay. So I'm going to lunge at, or swing my sword at C again. And hopefully it hits the time.
You can't touch me. You can't touch me. Okay, that's a hit.
Thank God.
Wow.
Nice.
Okay. What were you? You were thrusting it at him? Okay, you hit him in his bow holding arm, which is what, left handed?
No, at C. At C.
Yeah, you hit Charlie Cat in his bowing arm. Mm-hmm. And it's like, meow! He's changed. You can't touch me, too. Hey, you can't touch me! Meow. He hisses at you. Zombie?
What are you gonna do?
What the fuck am I gonna hit him with? I gotta hit him with.
If I remember right.
You got a loose bow, lamp oil.
If I remember right, Zombie, you did take another weapon, right?
I did pick up a bow.
And there is just a loose bow on the ground right now, right?
Yeah. Well, no, I did pick up that bow that the one cat dropped.
So use it.
Okay.
Now it's got a -2 to hit.
Okay, so hold on.
I'm trying to remember if you specialized in bow or blade.
Bow.
Okay, so it's like a -1 to hit.
So, okay. Was it damage or accuracy?
It is accuracy. You're rolling to hit. And you have to tell me which of the three cats you're rolling for.
Hold on, I gotta name it real quick. Okay.
Oh, because you don't have a bow in your inventory. I forgot about that.
Yeah. All right. It is good. I'm just going to name it bow for right now. It's not going to have any special name yet.
Okay.
Hey, shit.
Who are you trying to hit?
Me.
Oh, Demon Cat?
Yeah.
Demon Cat is so, like, in awe right now of Charlie Cat that he doesn't even notice the bow whiz by his head. Alfred Cat sees it and is freaked out, but it doesn't. No, it's there's nothing there.
Like, oh my god, he broke a dagger and now he's got a bomb.
Nordite.
Yes.
Nordy, stab.
I'm going for. Wait, who? Which one? Charlie Cat or Demon?
I don't care. Stab one of them.
Charlie Cat's hurting. Alfred Cat is hurting. Demon Cat is still in a little confusion and is really not living up to his name today.
Charlie Cat ho.
Charlie Cat. Charlie Cat, ho! Yeah, that's totally a hit.
First verse, same as the first. A little more loud and a little lot worse.
You getting a furry animal kicking at the end of your spear?
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Was that what you're calling her now?
Say what now?
Spyro, that's what it's calling it now.
Charlie Cat dead. Okay, give me. Make it good, Nordy. How did you kill him?
As I said, second verse, same as the first. A little more loud and a lot more worse.
So, okay. You swing your pole arm. What is it? A trident, right?
Yeah, it's a trident.
You swing your trident downwards, upwards, and to the side. And Charlie Cat tries to dance over to his right. But you weren't aiming towards his belly straight on. You were aiming sideways this time. And this time, you catch him in the neck. And your trident goes all the way through. And like cartoonish amounts of blood go all over the place.
Oh, Oh God!
Up goes the Neko.
Meanwhile, the ratings of the show go way down because children weren't ready to see this. What the hell are you doing, Marty? Children were not ready to see this.
Dead. Okay, I gotta say, fatality.
Oh my God.
So, okay, that's definitely a thing.
Okay,
and I guess, Queenie, you're next. You've just witnessed a cat die in a horrific way.
Oh, God.
Alfred Cat's still hurt, if you want to aim at him, and Demon Cat is now freaking out. He's like, oh, I wasn't ready to see this. Meow.
Yeah.
You're gonna die.
If I aim for Alpha, D's more than likely gonna fucking run. So I'm gonna aim for Alpha.
No.
What?
I
got long range, bitch.
It's... I want to see if he'll be my friend.
Oh God, that's right. You wanted to make him your pet.
Okay, fine. I'll aim for Demon Cat.
Are you aiming for the pot again?
No.
Okay.
I'm aiming for him. I'm gonna have to. It's gonna cost some magic too.
You know, you have like concentration. Nobody's touched any of these objects. You have things to help you hit.
I know. I'm hoarding right now. I'm gonna wait on that.
Hoarding? Once you guys leave this area, you're not going to be using these six objects.
No, I meant the concentration.
Okay. Just tell me what you're doing.
Alright, now I'm using shooting star again because I'm not used to me having magic.
That is true. They're not used to it either.
No, they're not used to it. So I'm going to be aiming for D, basically screaming out Moon Tiara. Magic. No, magic right. Moon Tiara. So I have to roll.
Okay, first off, deduct the magic points. Then you roll a sense check, which is basically your magic check.
Yep, it is 4 points, so...
It's an incantation, isn't it?
Yeah, so it's 4 points.
Yeah, it is. It's 4 points, okay.
Yeah, alright, that drops me there. Go to check. It's gonna be a magic check. If I can get the frick over to where I need to go. Alright,
I have the best combat music playing right now.
Oh my God.
It better be freaking Mortal Kombat.
Okay, magic check goes off without a hitch.
Can there be like a blood rage thing right now?
Alright, I roll damage. I forgot what my damage is for this one.
It is your spirit. Which, if I remember right, is pretty high.
Yeah, hold on. My pages are going. Because I have to keep flipping back and forth. I wish I had just extra stuff. Spirit is 8, so 1d8. Singe him just a little bit.
Okay, let me mark this down real quick. And armor isn't affected by magic, I don't think. Okay. Okay. You send your magical tiara flying towards Demon Cat's feet. And it bursts into flame and catches just his bottom paws on fire and it goes, ah, meow! And then he hisses at you, and he arches up his back and turns, like, slightly sideways and does that little bounce thing that cats does backwards a little bit.
Aww, I walk so with cute. The human herder.
So, let's see. Who's next? Oh, yeah, them.
Oh, God.
Okay, seeing the leaves was one thing. Seeing the fire burst out, Demon Cat immediately, like, fires off a shot at Queenie after regaining his composure and maybe licking his paw a little bit and putting it over his ear. Because he's a cat. Oh, he missed. He missed bad.
Good.
Alpha Cat is also scared of you, Queenie, and he attacks as well.
Great.
And no. Nope. That's such a no. That's such a terrible no.
Alright,
so both of their arrows miss you so bad that above your head you see them both hit each other and then just kind of clatter to the floor behind you, Queenie. Because that didn't work. Alright. Alyssa.
Okay, I'm gonna go after D with my sword. Probably in the stomach area somewhere. Yeah.
That totally hit.
Okay, come on, high damage. Yeah. Did something.
Okay, you go for his stomach, and because he jumped back because of the fireball, I'm going to say you just barely nick his, like, some of his fur off. His fur just goes, whoosh. They're not happy right now. Yeah. You guys still going for the kill, just out of curiosity?
We're going for yeah.
It's up to you guys.
Okay, zombie.
I take aim at D. I completely fucking miss.
You were too quick to pick up the bow and somehow shoot the bow backwards at the steps. You're not sure how. Nordy?
Who's still alive?
Alfred Cat is bleeding, but is really scared of Queenie. Demon Cat is singed and is really scared of Queenie.
Leave Alfred.
Yeah, Alfred Cat.
I'm assuming that I missed with that one.
You missed with that one.
That's fine.
Alright, I'm gonna go and head an arrow, basically to D, try to get up, again, aim for the pot.
Alright.
Why did you keep aiming for the pot?
Because, no, I'll let her tell you.
Okay, with Kinecos, they do not want to lose their pot. If they lose their pot, they have to stop and pick it up. Again, giving us an opportunity to get the fuck out of here.
Who wants to get the fuck out of here? I want to kill shit.
Yeah. Alright, fine. I'll aim for him then.
Okay.
They're already half dead anyway.
This is true. It's true. Alright, let's try this. Let's do this. Oh my god, I get something.
Nope.
Yeah. The bow sucks. I need a better bow.
you need a better bow.
I need a better bow.
And it was always meant to be in the back area for this anyway.
Yeah.
Okay. Demon Cat and Alfred Cat are kind of looking at Queenie and, like, all the bows in them and how busted up they are. And they kind of look at each other and they're both like, can we make a deal, meow? Like, they surrender. Like, they realize, like, they're looking at their dead friend spraying, like, blood all over the wall there. And they're just both kind of backing away going, Can we talk about this? And they both drop their bows, too. So they just have their paws up in the air, like...
What do you think, guys? Should we let him go, or should we finish killing him?
I want Alpha to be my friend and walk with me.
He won't.
What?
Go.
No deals in hell.
Go. Just go. Leave us the bows and just go.
No, 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 no. Not so fast. No, you ain't going nowhere. Not just yet, at least. You don't speak of what happened today. Got that?
Both of them nod. Like, they're nodding so vigorously, the pot on their head is toppling. He was like, that's fine. That's fine. Take the bows. Take everything.
Get out.
Meow. Sure.
And
sure.
Don't you rob
yours.
Them again.
Rob who? I don't even know who you're talking about. What in?
Try this again.
What in? We gotta go.
Yep.
They very carefully edge around you. Like, especially Queenie. They're on the opposite side of the hall from Queenie with both of their paws up, very quickly backing out of, you know, of the stairwell. And then just once they hit the top door, I'm going to assume you guys aren't shooting them. They disappear. You don't see them again. You will never see Alfred Cat or Demon Cat again, unless you go hunting for them, I guess. So
why couldn't I try and make him my friend?
They don't want you.
Well, first off, they really don't trust humans. And second off, they really, really don't trust humans who send fireballs at them and arrows and swords and cut the shit out of them. It kind of ruins the relationship.
I've had worse.
So.
Before Nordy can, I pick up my teeth.
No, you don't.
Yeah.
No, you don't.
Or you just knock him out later.
If you guys really want to make this a thing, both of you roll initiative. Whoever rolls highest gets zombie's teeth. It is a size 1 object.
Zombie can have his teeth. I don't want him. That's gross.
He wants my teeth.
Fuck.
Zombie gets his teeth.
Elisha. Wait, he's still hurting. I beat the shit out of Zombie.
No, I'm not doing that tonight. I'm done with combat.
I'm back at
home. My teeth!
No, I realize DMs aren't supposed to just say no outright, but you're tired, Nordy. I'm going to say no to that right now, just so I can move the game forward.
Do I still have the head of the one Neko Goblin on the pike, or did
yep.
it?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. That's my trophy.
There you go.
Severed head of a cat. It is a size 3 object if you want to put him into your inventory.
Oh no, it's not in my inventory. It's on the pike, and it's going to stay there until we get back.
How are we going to take all the bows back, guys? They're size 3.
I'll pick one up. I'm actually going to try to see if I can keep one of them.
Okay. There are 8 bows here.
Hold on.
Did somebody have the good idea to bring one of the orangutans with them?
No. If I say yes, will it be acceptable?
Shit, man. You guys didn't mention it, and you just started searching. I don't know. How can I resolve this? What's a good way to resolve this?
I can run back to camp and grab one.
It's a day's journey.
She is fast.
Oh, it is a day's journey?
Yeah, you guys made a travel check for a reason. It is a day's journey from the inn.
I'm only at 6 out of 20 items. So I can carry quite a few of them.
What was yours?
Because of his backpack.
Yeah, he has his backpack on him.
I'm at 5 and 21.
Yeah, I have a backpack also.
Okay. Oh, also, if you're interested, there are 4 daggers that the Nekos had before they started using the bows.
Yes.
So that's 8 bows, 4 daggers total, and I am going to roll a die. Even, you brought the orangutans. Odd, you go without orangutans. Fair?
Sounds fair.
Okay. Even. Orangutan. Odd, no orangutan. No orangutan.
That's fine.
Right.
Well, but, yeah, I have capacity. Where is my... How do you find out what you can hold?
It's under inventory.
It's also kind of funky because the capacity is busted. So here's the best way to do it. If you have a backpack... Like, take your normal capacity, which is strength plus 3. If you have a backpack, add whatever capacity that has. So a large backpack, for example, gives you a 10 capacity. And then subtract the size of every item that you have on you, including weapon. I know it's complicated. It didn't have to be this complicated, but Their okay. system on this particular sheet is all flubbered up.
This is in my inventory according to that rule as well.
I only have a 2 left.
I can hold a couple of bows, at least.
Well, 30. First thing for me is I throw away that broken dagger and I grab 2 of the daggers on the ground.
That's fine. They're a size 1 object. You can just keep them on you.
Okay, so size 1.
I can carry a bow in my head pack, and I can carry 2 bows in my backpack.
Okay, so that's 6 between me and her. That leaves 2 left to carry.
I can carry them.
Was that Pyro who said that?
No, that was Zombie.
Okay, sorry. I didn't look at the little light up thing. Zombie, also keep in mind you have 2 daggers on you, but,
just leave the daggers. You got the daggers you need.
Well, two daggers is pretty normal, I would think, considering.
Well, no, I grabbed 2 daggers for my own use. I'm not grabbing the other 2. Okay, I have 12 capacity I can carry. How much are those?
3 each.
Okay.
Eliza, are you getting the... Are you doing a trapping check on the 2 dead Nekas?
I will now.
Wait, why?
For
I can skin them?
Yeah, it... Oh, no, wait, you don't skin Nekos. Nobody wants Neko fur. That's gross.
Trapping? Then why?
Well, because it creatures don't have drops, but they do have things that you can get from them. In the case of the Nekos, it's pot.
Okay.
Wait, I can get weed?
Now,
I do 1 or 2 checks?
One for each.
I don't know.
1 for each?
1 trapping for each.
Wait, I can do the same thing if she fails, right?
Yeah, you're a hunter, yeah. And they are level 4 critters, so I think you need to roll... I think twice what there is.
Wait, what?
Hang on, I'm doing this real quick.
Jordy can do the same thing.
Yes.
Yep.
I should have checked this out. There it is. Okay, so you need to roll above an 8. So one of them check and... Oh, Nordy was rolling for the other one. Okay.
So she rolled twice to check both of them. Failed on one of them.
Okay, and Nordy, you tried to compensate by rolling for the one she failed for?
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure. So, okay, the pot on top of the Neko's head that is on top of Nordy's pike, it's cracked. It was cracked as soon as it hit the wall. But the other pot is fine. And I'm going to play a little bit with this because it does not say a pot. It just says pot. So in that pot is pot.
Yeah!
I'm sorry, makers of the game. You should have been more specific. It just says pot.
Well, I'm going to take it and put it in my inventory for later.
So I will say that it hits.
Hey, Zombie, we'll smoke this later.
Yes.
Hey, what about me?
You, Nordy, you do.
It's going to act the same as alcohol, and it's a size 1 item.
Nice.
As long as we're turning everything into a frat party, might as well go all the way.
Yeah, might as well go full shebang. Shebang, shebang.
So I added.
There we go. Don't save. So, all right. After everything was said and done for the night, and you've gathered up all of the stuff, who is making a camp check?
Can I go hunting first?
Yes.
Can we go hunting first for food? Because if we didn't bring the orangutans, guess what we don't have, guys?
Actually, that's not true.
Yeah, if you guys have water... Well, there is...
I have water and rations for 3.
There is water. There's like a barrel of water in this crypt already. I mean, the Nekos did have to survive on their own, but they went hunting every night, so they don't have any food.
So I'll make a camp check.
I've got two rations.
Okay, Queenie, give yourself a plus one to your camp check because you're in a place where Nekos were camping. They did most of the work for you, in other words. Seven's good.
We can use the leaves as bedding.
There's the that. Although, you will say that there's a nice little, like, cat bed over in the corner of this crypt where one of the Nekos were sleeping, Queenie. So there's that, too.
Yay.
Someone gonna lend me a ration?
Yeah. I'm giving
Are you guys hunting?
Oh. I can. Although I'm injured from the fight, I don't really want
to
hunt.
I'll go hunting. I'm at full I'm at full HP. They didn't do a damn thing to me. Let's roll.
Go hunt.
Okay. Let's see. You are in grasslands, so it is a... Why is there a camp check from Larissa?
I thought we were all doing one.
No, it's just Queenie. She was setting up camp. It's usually her and Walrus that are setting up camp. So yeah, all right. It's a difficulty 8 around these areas. Even with the rain, you should be able to find something delicious to cook.
How about a 7?
7? Okay, that is...
Unacceptable!
I'm trying to remember. It's the difference, isn't it? Yeah, it's the difference. So that's one... Good. Okay, you can find a good skull bunny.
Cool.
And hit it with the back of your spear because you don't want to poke it with the front of your spear because it's got a dead Neko head on it.
I just walk up and go pat. Dinner.
Yay. So that's one delicious rations. Larissa, are you hunting?
Baby, I have weekend.
I'm gonna just use one of my rations.
I'm gonna eat my delicious ration.
Queenie
I'm gonna also give one to Zombie because he doesn't have any, right?
No, he's got 2. He said. Well.
Oh, okay.
Wait, does the camp check double as a hunt check?
No, shouldn't.
Mm-mm. No, I have a hunting different check.
Yeah. So roll your hunting check.
Me?
No, I've already done that. I went hunting. She did not. She's got rations.
Yeah, I've got rations in my pack.
Oh, okay. And Nordy, you're just gonna eat your own rations.
Yes, I had to go hunting for my own food.
Okay.
Because I had nothing.
And Queenie wants me to stop squeaking. Sorry.
Yes. And I have no food.
Oh, whoops.
Well, you've got four rations and 4 people. You'll be okay.
Okay.
I can give her one of my rations.
Right.
Thank you.
Okay, so I'll have
make
one
you. I'll make your leaves dead.
And I have my delicious ration.
The rabbit. The delicious rabbit.
Question, how are you going to cook without a fire?
She set up camp. We have a fire.
Yeah, there's a fire in the crypt. It's really smoky.
Well.
But it's nice and warm. And considering that it was raining outside all day today, it's pretty cozy. So, yeah, you guys are doing all right tonight.
You know what? I will pick up those other daggers.
Might as well. I mean, worst that can happen is you sell them.
Exactly. Right?
Now, the good news is when you travel tomorrow, there is food waiting for you, so that's nice. Also, you can just talk to the innkeeper and I'm sure spend a little bit of the gold that you make off of these bows.
This is true.
Yep.
So, let me get this straight. All 4 daggers are accounted for, and all 8 bows are accounted for.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I guess y'all go to sleep, unless you want to do something before the night comes.
Yeah. I'm eating.
Just sleep.
Okay. So.
Wait, who's doing watch?
Do we have to?
I don't think anybody else knows we're here.
I'm just going to tell you, the Nekos aren't coming back.
I was about to say, I think they're good, honestly.
If they do, they'll regret it.
Right? All right, so we have to do...
I know my mana points heal up in the morning. Do my health points too if I have...
Okay, here's how that works. As you sleep, if you're sleeping well, as it is, just normal camp, your hit points multiply times two, your current hit points. If that puts you at full health, then you're at max health. Your your mental points fully heal with a good night's rest.
Okay.
Do we have a good night's sleep at the camp, Chef?
Yeah, you rolled a pretty good camp.
Okay.
Everything goes back to normal. Camp.
Right.
Kind of, sorta, yeah.
Because we kind of stole it.
Kind of made it our own.
And I will say that you guys do hear a chirping noise, like a bug noise in the dark with you, but it only lasts for like 1 hour into the night, and then it just shuts up.
It's one of those stupid crickets, ain't it?
It's a cricket, yeah.
I don't know if you want to try and find it, it's out there, though. All right, so...
Does it sound like a cricket?
It sounds a little like a cricket, yeah.
Then it's a fucking cricket.
Well, if it moves like a cricket and it sounds like a cricket, then it's a fucking cricket.
I think there's a reason he's telling us this. Somebody should go find the cricket.
Fuck well, it's it. Up to you if you want to... If you can ignore it, you don't have to. I don't care.
Somebody go find the cricket. There's something about this. I know it.
Oh, my God.
I'll go look for the cricket.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to roll for an animal tracking for the fucking cricket.
It's a sense check. It's just a sense check. A sense?
Really?
Just yeah, you're looking. It's your senses. It's what? It's...
I'll look for the cricket.
Okay, you look for the cricket. You probably got higher yellow boxes.
I can honestly say you do not find the cricket.
All right.
Cast for animal tracking.
Okay. I will say that this is not something you can track. It doesn't leave tracks. It's a cricket.
Yeah, so. Yeah.
I'm tracking the sound.
Okay, for the hour that it's there, it's driving you guys nuts. And eventually it just shuts up.
Can I do a sense check for the cricket?
Like, you guys are looking all over for the goddamn cricket, but you don't find the cricket. I'm just calling it now. You don't find the cricket. I'm not making this an automatic thing. You try. You honestly try. But that's the end of it. It shuts up, and then you don't know where it's coming from.
All right. Can we just go to sleep now?
Yes.
All right.
I want to see if I can find the cricket.
No.
No.
Everything. So you guys go to sleep. You actually sleep pretty good because you just did a hard day's fight. If you are below health, multiply or below maximum health, multiply your health and go to max. Restore your mental points, blah blah blah, and then everybody make a condition check. Nordy, you get a +1 because you were
delicious.
Yeah, your food was your rabbit was delicious.
You were delicious. Okay.
Queenie, you get a +1 because you did a crit in your travel check and you just feel good the previous day. Holy fuck!
Total success. I'm walking on sunshine. Whoa!
I'm following you with that one, apparently.
And don't it feel good?
So, Queenie, yours is actually 11, not 10.
Okay, yeah, I don't know why my 1 didn't pop up. I put it in.
Zombie, you cannot catch a break today.
Jesus, dude.
Must be all that stabbing and missing teeth.
He's left with a stone in his back.
Nah, he had a leaf up his butt.
And Larissa, you wake up and you're awake.
Oh, she can cast that thing on herself.
I can.
Yes, you can. Alright.
Not wasting the mana.
So Zombie, why do you feel like shit, dog?
Yeah, dude.
Let us count the ways.
I feel fucking amazing.
Okay, Nordy, since you did a crit success, you can pick one of your stats, and for the rest of the day, it is upgraded one die.
All right, hang on, let me go over here.
And just tell me which one you're picking, so I can keep track.
Let's go with strength for now.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and make the change to a D10, right?
Yep. It go if it's a D8, it's a D10 now.
Got it.
Nice. Why? Oh God!
My hands on the
here. All right. So
my snore keep you up, zombie.
That's what it was.
So the trip back is going to take another travel check. But here's the thing: before you were following a trail. It's going to be a little harder to get back this time. So somebody has to be cartographer and roll a direction check. But first, do you guys want to do anything before you make the travel?
Let's look around.
I want to herb gather.
Okay, Queenie, roll that. I keep forgetting what it is.
It's strength and intelligence.
Oh, gosh, really?
So first off, everybody gets a fumble point.
Everybody clap your hands.
Oh, God, I suck.
Wow, I need to look this up real quick.
How many of those are we supposed to have, then?
Four. I
have four.
Nobody has spent a single fumble point yet, so everybody should have the same amount tonight.
Alyssa should have three because she joined us a day late. One of those fumble points came from the first day.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yep. So you should have, a three, Alyssa.
Alyssa should have three.
Yeah, because Wall was the first one that fumbled, I believe. Yeah,
Wall was the first to fumble.
Why is that not a surprise?
Right?
I have yet to fumble.
Just your face.
Wait, you can search for herbs during combat? What the fuck?
I didn't know that. I thought it was only during the day. I could search.
Well, then that's a thing.
I don't know. Oh my god.
It's like, I'm just going to stop fighting. There's like three dragons around me. I'm going to search for herbs.
Oh god, why?
I was just like, pretty flowers. In the middle. Wait, I see one. Hang on, guys. I see one.
No, like, sorry, I would never do that.
My mind's immediately going back to WoW. I'm in the middle of fighting off just random mob monsters. It's like, hey, look. Plant. Yeah.
Oh, a cookie.
Hmm.
Oh, dear.
Hmm.
Yeah, I would not do that.
So okay. Queenie, here's what I'm going to do. And this may sound a little bit mean for now. Pick one item in your inventory that you've lost.
No!
Oh, no.
Oh, my God, why?
Because you were carrying your stuff with you, and you went herb searching, and you thought you saw one, and it caused you to fall into a hole. But you catch yourself before you hurt yourself. However, something falls out of your backpack, and you're not sure what it is. Well,
no.
I mean, so when you check your inventory, you found that you lost something.
Oh man! Okay, it's gonna be my flowstone.
Okay, now here's the next thing, because I'm gonna give you a chance to find that flowstone.
Okay.
Because you can't.
Flowstone basically makes a sauna.
Wait. Oh yeah, that's I forgot about that.
Yes.
Okay, so. Roll gather herbs again, but this is you searching for your flowstone.
Okay. Because I would like to, use that eventually. Please.
Yes, you find it.
Yay! I didn't lose my flowstone, yo. Yay.
You actually just find it. Like, you just see the gleam in the back of the hole. And then you realize that the hole you're in is a grave!
What?
Anyway, it's a clear day. You can clearly see the pumpkin moon sun thing in the sky that's illuminating you. And, I don't know if you guys are ready to roll, but,
zebra is just sitting. Around. I want to search around for a second.
Okay, what are you searching for?
Anything out of the ordinary. Just something that's in case someone might have left behind.
Oh.
I have this strange feeling that someone has snuck up on us at night and left something. It's called on.
That would be what, perception?
Well, I'm going to tell you right out being the suspicious sort, you don't see anything in the crypt that you didn't see the previous night. All of the leaves are still there. All of the barrel of water is still there. That kind of thing. Okay. I will give you this much, though. Roll a sense check and roll high.
Damn it.
Because there is... I will say that, yes, there is something hidden amongst you.
Okay.
But it's going to be a little difficult to see him. Her.
Can I use a concentration and a fumble point?
Yeah. Just reduce the fumble points by one and add a plus one to your sense check.
What about a concentration and a fumble? Can I use both of those?
Oh, you're using both?
Yes.
Okay. Then also reduce your mental points by two, or by half, and then roll it plus two.
How about an 11?
11's really good.
11's, yeah, it is.
11's up over a 9, which is what you were supposed to... 11's pretty good.
Roll high.
Right?
Okay. And Norty, you're the only one who sees this.
Okay.
As you look around, you were sharp-eyed today. And you do notice a glint. Now, it's not even a glint. It's just sort of there. And at first, it doesn't... It makes... How do I word this? It's so mundane, it shouldn't mean anything to anyone. On top of the crypt, where you guys just came out, is a scarab. And it just sort of crawls away. It flies off. It's so mundane, nobody should have caught it. It doesn't mean anything. Except you realize that scarabs aren't native to New Salem.
Can I fire at it?
No, it's on the other side of the crypt. It flew off. You don't know where it is.
No, y'all don't see it. I'm the only one who does.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I thought that was you. Darn it. I need to learn your voices.
Okay, if $5, if it's a, can I fire at it? Can I stab it? $5, that's a zombie.
Okay.
Yeah. Can I stab that. It? Can I fire it? Can I make money off of it? Is either going to be Hound or Norty?
Now, if you keep searching for it, you don't see it again. But it shouldn't mean anything, but it does. You know?
It's just something that kind of sticks out that shouldn't be there.
Yeah, it's just right. Like
I don't like that.
It's just something odd, like walking by on the street in modern day New York and finding a shoeshine place, and you're like, oh, well, there's. Of course there's a shoeshine place in New York. And then you walk away going, wait a second, who the fuck shines their shoes nowadays? Yeah, it's that kind of thing.
It's unsettling.
And so I'm only giving you this because you rolled a fucking 11.
Yeah, I'm putting that in my notes.
Sure, put it in your notes.
Shiny scarab, right?
It's just a scarab. Wasn't really shiny. My mind immediately went to RPG land where there's always a glint on important things. It was just a scarab, though, but it was out of place. Out of place scarab.
It was on top of the crib.
Yeah.
All right.
And what the hell, I'll say that it sounded like a cricket.
Someone just dropped their shit.
I may have done what undercooked analysis calls shitting the bed by giving that piece of detail, but I'm trying to make a connection here.
No, you're fine.
All right.
Shitting the bed.
Oh, shit the bed is when you make a mess of everything. It's like, oh, you just fucked up. You just shit everything. You just shit the bed. And they use it to explain stories that they're reading, and suddenly the story says, and then the black-eyed children showed up, and were spooky, and like, oh no, you just shit the bed. You were doing so great, and then you shit the bed.
So wait, you shit the bed, or I shit the bed?
Nah, neither of us shit the bed. I feel like I shit the bed. Shat the bed.
Okay.
Shitted. shit chat.
Okay, so how about that travel check, guys?
Yeah.
All right.
It shouldn't mean much, but we'll go through it. It is a clear day. Just roll a 6 or above.
Done.
Looks good. Looks good.
Oh wait, don't I get a plus one to my travel check anyway because I'm feeling so sprightly and free?
No, you get a bonus to your strength because you feel so sprightly and free.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that thing.
You feel fucking incredible.
Hey, Queenie, thanks for my new fumble point that I just used.
Damn it!
Okay.
I'm not having a good day, y'all.
Nah, Zombie, you're having a rough time, I realize. So, okay, I'm just looking up the rules here for a fumble on travel. Zombie...
What?
You... As you're walking back...
I fumbled.
I didn't fumble, please.
No, you did not fumble, but you did roll under. Give me a second. This is going to be so good. So good is what this is going to be. So as you're walking back to the town and you get closer to the town, right?
Yeah.
Zombie, you trip on one half of a rock. And it's the same goddamn rock that you cut in half with your stabbing arm just yesterday. But that's not the worst of it. The worst, because as you're getting up going, son of a bitch, it's the same rock, you look over and Queenie trips on the other half of the rock and then causes her to fall into a cave. It takes you guys an hour to get her out. And Queenie, I hate to do this to you, Queenie, quarter your hit points.
Quarter my hit points?
In other words, whatever it is, divide it by half and divide it by half again.
I have 2 hit points then.
Yes, you have 2 hit points. You
also
trip.
No one did a direction check.
Oh no, the direction check comes afterwards. But
oh god damn, okay.
Who's gonna make the direction check, by the way?
What's it take for a direction check again?
It is intelligence times 2. So intelligence plus intelligence.
Who has the highest intelligence that's not Nordy?
Mines are D8.
I'm just saying, don't let Queenie do it.
Mines are D6s.
Mine's D4.
I got it.
Okay.
And then I was just going to say, I've got to cast a heal spell on Queenie.
Thank you.
The double cure thing.
Love me.
I can't.
Yeah, you're fine. Direction check is fine. You guys make it back to town completely fine, except for poor Queenie, who fell down a hole, tripping on a rock that was giving its revenge.
Fucking rock. Fucking rock.
That is weird, isn't it? Is it Pyro?
No, because you hear Call of Duty. You actually hear Call of Duty.
Do I heal her for? Which one do I do that?
If you're using Cure Touch, we've done this a couple of times. Oh, wait, you've already made your roll.
Yeah, the sense check. I thought I had to roll one for how much I healed her.
Oh, it's... Oh, God. Hang on, I gotta look up magic again. Cure Touch is... Are you doing the Cure Plus Plus?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's your intelligence plus 1d6.
So 2d6 then.
Mm-hmm. So, Queenie, you get something that you're not used to. You get a slap on the ass. And you kind of like it.
A lot.
You involuntarily purr when it happens. All right, so... So, okay, Queenie gets hit points back. You guys make it to the inn.
Do I get all of my hit points back?
Do you have less than 8 max? I don't remember what your hit points were.
Hold on.
I think you have, like... Yeah, I think you just have 8 hit points, so I think you may have just maxed out.
Okay, I have to be real fast. I'll be back.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So I get all my hit points back. Alright.
So, alright. With some excitement with a rock... And a tell to tell walrus and hound. You guys make it back to the inn. Did I just lose everyone? Okay, no.
No.
Sorry.
No.
Sorry. I thought I'd. Okay, that's Nord doing Call of Duty.
Yeah. No, I'm fine.
All right. We're winding down, aren't we?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay. Let's just get this over with. Zombie, if you want to sell any of your knives?
Yeah, I sell 2 knives and 2 bones.
Okay. Well, we'll wrap up the whole gold thing together, I guess, for the bows. Shopkeep is interested in the knives and will give you normal fare for it, so it's 200 gold each for the knives.
Sweet.
Nordy made a deal with the innkeeper for 400 gold for each bow.
No, that was Zombie who did that.
Yeah, that was Zombie.
That was Zombie.
Was it
that
Zombie? Was Zombie?
Yeah. Noble, yeah.
It feels so long ago.
He said he was going to give 400. I didn't realize it was just me.
All right. With all the bows together...
8 times 400 is 3,200.
So that's 3,200 gold. I'll let you guys split it up however you like.
Well, it's 800 a person then.
Fight. Oh, okay.
No, 800 a person.
That works too.
Yeah, plus 400.
I agree. 800 a person. That works for me.
I get 1,200 gold.
So, you guys are starting to rack up like a normal amount of gold for adventurers now.
Ah, kitten.
Okay.
How do I get rid of stuff in my inventory?
Oh, I think you hit modify and there's an option to delete it.
I have 1,200 gold.
Haha. Wait, how much gold do I get off of that?
If everybody split it up evenly, it was 800 gold.
You get 400 gold?
800. Unless you're Zombie who got 400 more gold for selling his daggers.
I already had 400 gold, so mine's now with the 800, 1,200.
Woo!
I have 1,840 gold.
I have 1,360. I'm happy.
So I got 800 gold off of that. That puts me up to 1,600.
Nice!
Now, the innkeeper would love to give you guys a discount on some delicious food. So if you want to buy some delicious food... it'll be 20 gold instead of the normal 30 price. He's knocking that off as a way to say thank you for getting all of his armaments back. He has no idea why they were stealing bows. I mean, he have you seen Neko-Goblins? They're terrible at bows. Nobody gets hit with them.
Yeah, I should know.
And he will give you an extra...
I'm wondering why he hasn't realized that... I have a Neko head still on my pike, on my trident here.
Realize it, he applauds it. He hates Neko goblins.
Alright, so I got 800 gold.
And since you guys helped him out, he will waive tonight's fare on yesterday and today's fucking... price. Shit, yeah. I don't even... My brain is draining out my ear. I'm sorry.
How much was it to stay again?
It was 20, but for yesterday and today, since it took you guys that long to get all the bows back, he's waiving it, so he's not charging you anything tonight.
Wait,
or
so
yesterday.
I get my money back that I spent from last night?
Yep.
You weren't here last night.
Yes, I was.
No, you were sleeping in a crypt.
No, I'm talking about the night before... Oh, wait, hang on.
Yeah. He's not charging us because the other people were there.
Yeah, it is...
Oh, the other D-D-D's. I forgot about them.
It is the 6th of summer, all right? He's saying that for the night of the 5th of summer, he is not charging you, which was yesterday. And the night of the 6th of summer, which is today, he is not charging you. If you're staying tomorrow, he will charge you again.
That's fine. Who's the head guy around here again? Like, who's the one that's got, like, the most information?
That would be the innkeeper. Hello, how can I help you? Again.
Again? I didn't know if it might have been the bartender.
He's the same guy.
Yeah.
Same guy?
Okay. Yeah, he runs the Voorhees cabins.
Is everyone still around, or what's going on, or are they gone?
The travelers have long since left. Right now, you guys are the only tenants in town. There is also a general store owner across the street. There is the innkeeper's wife,
What is Zombie, Queenie, and Alyssa doing?
I'm going to the general store to see if he's got string.
Okay.
String? Oh my god, string, of course.
Smoke my weed and drink my alcohol.
Okay, Queenie, what are you doing?
Smoke the weed and drink the beer?
Right?
No, whiskey, but yeah. Don't do beer.
I'm gonna get food.
Okay. While they're off doing that, I wanna have a conversation with the innkeeper.
I bought food too. I took it off my thing.
Okay. First off, everybody, if you go to the equipment section, the general store. Okay. The general store sells, like, general goods and traveling gear.
Okay.
Or, I'm sorry, not traveling gear. Fuck, because that's actually something else. No, just general items. It's small items and the camping equipment and rations and sundries, that kind of shit. And he does sell grandfather clocks, just for the fuck of it. Why not? There's a big future in grandfather clocks.
How much are their rations again?
Rations aren't much. They're 5 for regular. Delicious rations. Or no, I'm sorry. Oh, that's... Okay. Travel rations are 10 per... Delicious rations are 70 per, but they give you a +1 bonus. So if you want to buy rations, there you go.
Yeah, I'm just going to buy regular rations. They're 10 per, you said?
Yeah.
None of us want your grandfather clock.
Sorry, Nordy. I'll get to you in a sec.
That's fine.
I'm going to grab $80 worth of rations.
Sure. And you can load it up onto the orangutans, I guess.
Yep.
And if anybody is... getting delicious food from the innkeeper tonight, it gives you a +1 to your condition on the next time. And it is delicious. His wife is a great cook.
Alright. I'll be getting that at the same later, but I want to have a talk with the innkeeper since no one is around.
Okay. Innkeeper's like, what can I do you for?
Has there been any sightings of scarabs in the vicinity as of late? Because I know they're not really native to this location, but...
I have heard of scarabs before, but... I've never seen one other than in books.
Okay. Do you know anyone who might know?
Aren't they desert critters? I mean, there's a desert far to the west, but...
How far?
On the other side of the mountain.
Still too far for them to be around here.
That's just to give you an idea. If Hound were around and he's got some travel sense, even if you were to go as the crow flies, right? It would be 5, 10, 15. Hang on a second. 5, 10, 15, 20. It would be 21 days to get to the desert. Even if you ignored climbing a mountain and went as the crow flies.
That's kind of fucked up. That should not be the way it is.
Most people take a carriage, and most people take that carriage away from the desert because it's terrible.
Rations are size 1?
All rations are size 1 each.
Okay.
And you can buy a crate and throw it onto an orangutan. You got 2 of them.
Yeah.
I mean 3 of them. You got 3 of them. I forgot about Wilson.
also gonna buy 8 rations, so I'm down.
I'm gonna buy delicious food for tonight.
Okay, that's 20.
Okay, so that's 20 out of my gold. Got it.
And tonight's delicious rations is delicious spiral cut ham with pineapple on top. And some corn, mashed potatoes, the best buttery biscuits you've ever had, and macaroni and cheese.
You're a southern man at heart. You know that.
Well, actually, it's what I ate today.
Don't forget there was asparagus and corn. They were just
oh, yeah, there's asparagus and corn also, if you want
to. You lost me at asparagus.
All right.
I don't like asparagus either.
Anyway. I'm going to buy some rations.
EXP.
Are we calling it a night? Is it time to?
Can I buy some rations first?
Sure. Oh. While you're doing that, I'm gonna figure out XP for everybody.
All right.
I need to make me my pound food.
Okay, let me see here.
How much are rations again?
10.
They're 10.
Mm-hmm.
Graham.
Yeah.
Buy 2 rations and put them.
What's
on
up?
The,
I'm looking at the sundries in the general store.
Uh huh.
Can I exchange that for like some string?
I'll say he has a thing of twine. That's
okay. How much does it cost?
It'll cost you 10 gold.
Okay, I buy one.
Okay, it'll give you 50 feet of twine all wrapped up. Wait, is 50 big? No, 50's not that big, right?
Of
like,
twine, you're yeah, looking at like a...
That's like a handful of twine, right? It's like a ball of twine.
Yeah.
Shit ton of twine.
Yeah. It was originally meant to entertain Nekos, but like to distract them. But in fact, you know what? Yeah. Yeah. I will give you the choice of either using it to make a tooth necklace or to distract a Neko next time you encounter one.
Well, I will need a small piece to make the necklace. I don't need 50 feet to make a necklace. That's a lot of fucking... That's a big-ass necklace.
Or you could give the rest to me.
So, why can't I just do both?
Motherfucker, I forgot the benediction again.
It's okay.
Ah... So, okay, nobody triggered
remember
the benediction.
Remember that time that I stabbed that guy and his head fell off and went onto my pike? Good time.
Congratulations, for the rest of the session, you are immune to mental statuses, which means you can get drunk all you want.
Yeah, give me some of that weed.
All right. So, Grim, can I make my necklace?
Can you make your necklace?
Yes, with the teeth from the direwolves and my teeth.
What are you going to use to make it? I mean, yeah, they're teeth, but are you going to wrap the thing around?
Yeah, we're just going to wrap it around.
You know what? I don't really see any reason why I shouldn't allow you to do that. Call it a size 1 item, necklace of teeth. It's kind of grim, and it's also gross, so it's got a gross status to it. But, yeah. Yeah, gross necklace is what you make.
Yeah. I don't want to make a gross necklace. I want to make a teeth necklace.
And that is, trust me, man, teeth necklace in this world is still gross. Because it's all like jaggedy and different animals, and it's got your teeth in it. Oh, God.
Yes.
Whose teeth am I kicking in?
Nobody's teeth. Hi.
Hi.
Walrus, zombie may come to you and ask you to make him a tooth necklace, so it isn't gross.
That's disturbing.
You said I could.
Whoa! You freaking missed it.
Yeah.
Everybody who played tonight gets 140 experience.
Nice.
Woo.
Yet again. Whoa! You missed.
And when we start again, it will be the 7th of summer.
Okay, so what's the thing to go from level 2 to level 3? How much do I need?
600.
Okay.
How much experience are we getting?
140.
140? Okay.
Okay.
So I take it you had a good night tonight.
We did.
It was pretty entertaining.
I went into a bloodlust.
Fuck yeah.
Zombie fell over so many times.
He falls over anyway.
I got rock. Walrus, we have 5 fumble points.
Oh, Jesus Christ.